on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and TikTok.
93.5 and 107.5. The Fan.
WIBC HD2 W298BB. WIBC HD3 W228CX. Indianapolis.
The Pacers head to the Big Apple to face the New York Knicks tomorrow night at 7 on 93.5 and 107.5 The Fan.
When was the last time you practiced your home fire escape plan? Be sure everyone in your family knows what to do if there's a fire. Get out, stay out. It's your fire safe response.
Your one blood donation can help save the lives of up to 3 people. Give blood through the American Red Cross to help hospital patients. Visit redcrossblood.org today.
What in the hell do you think you're doing?
Hey, John boy.
I'm telling you straight, it's my way or the highway. If anybody wants to walk, do it now.
Hey, everybody, we're all gonna get laid.
And again, it's picked up. It's Darius Leonard, a pick six for the Maniac. Touchdown, INDY. Yes, sir.
Oh, the chicken. Double time.
Miles Turner.
Yeah.
John, I have never been better to be on the air with you here in Indianapolis, a place where so many of my dreams have come true.
The Ride with JMV on 93.5 and 107.5, The Fan.
I mean, look, we're starting that process. I mean, obviously, we're not good enough. I mean, you finished 4-12-1. I'm not going to sit up here and act like, oh, you know what? We had a Super Bowl roster and it's everybody. No, we're not. At the end of the day, we're not good enough. And we got to figure out the areas we're not good enough. Do I think we're our talent is not like we're like when I walked in here in 17, I thought we had some talent issues that we had to correct. I do think there's some building pieces here. They got to play better. You know, our best players got to play to their standard. But I don't think we're void of talent. We need to add more talent, and there's areas that we need to get better at, but I don't think we're complete void of talent.
Right, from earlier today, that's Chris Ballard. We got a lot of stuff to play. We've got a lot of opinion to get to, a lot of guests to have on this show, and because that is what we do when we give back to the public. You guys are the ones that are going to the games. You guys are the ones that are paying to go to these games, paying to support the team, being a part of it. Love it when the fall rolls around because the NFL season starts. You tell me how you feel about this decision as well. You already know how I feel. Now, I will tell you this. I am not with those because this is how I feel about what he said, and in particular when Chris Ballard started with, I failed. I have failed. That is the equivalent, really, of like JMV sucks, because you go, hey, JMV sucks. Oh, I know. Well, I failed. That is, to me, incredibly sincere. And I'm not going to challenge any of the sincerity that is going on here, because I would not want my level of sincerity challenged. But it's not just about 1 year. I don't have an axe to grind. I don't have an agenda as to why I think it's time to start over. I just think it's logical after 6 years, and now you're going into an off season to where you're going to have to cobble something together to hopefully find that quarterback of the future. Unless you like somebody that's going to fall into your lap, and then we'll all have questions about that, but whatever. So you're going to start with that new quarterback, that long-term quarterback, and hopefully you get that thing right, whomever it is. You're going to start with a new head coach. Now, it could be Jeff Saturday, the interim head coach. And Chris Ballard again today said all the right things regarding that. Or at least as much as he could. You could tell that he was not going to be on board with it, but he was not going to throw a Golden Era member and a member of the Ring of Honor under the bus. He wasn't going to do that. But let's face it. And to me, you're going to start with a new head coach. You're going to start with a new quarterback. Then you need to also just reset everything here. Like, we all understand where we're going. They have tried to Band-Aid this up, you know, weld this together, bit by bit, piece by piece for the past couple of years. Now, because of your four-win crappy season, you're in this position. Why don't you just hit the reset button? Why is it not okay to do that? Again, I'm not going to challenge his sincerity on where this team is and laying the blame on himself, but I would challenge, where else are you going to lay that blame? Outside of the owner, and you're not going to blame him because he's allowing you to come back. But where else is that blame going to be? I think everybody has substantially blamed Frank Reich for being soft, for being loose, for not taking care of stuff. At least this kind of slowly but surely does come out. You've laid the blame on Carson Wentz. Everybody still blames Andrew Luck. And I'm not suggesting that none of this had issues, but when you're the general manager, that's what has to be done. You got to take on that ownership. I don't know why anybody would have gone in there and would have expected anything less. So it really didn't change my thought. And again, my thoughts are not just built into a really crappy, one of the crappiest of all time, if not the crappiest of all time, four-win seasons. My thought in all this is, where are they after 6 years? Where are they well after the Luck saga? Where are they after this quarterback and that quarterback? And I do realize that the owner had his fingerprints all over this. Now, the reason why you went out and you targeted Matt Ryan was because the owner wanted no more of Carson Wentz, and the owner was mad because the now former head coach talked him in to bringing Carson Wentz in. Mad about that. But you can't get rid of the owner. You're not going to get rid of the owner. So my thought all along is just to go ahead and reset. And a lot of people said, oh, you just sound like you have an axe to grind. Zero. None whatsoever. I'm assuming everybody over there fully understands that. I don't come on here every day to challenge folks just because I'm in a bad mood or because I'm chafing or I'm mad about something that somebody has done, hence the axe to grind. Nah, I just kind of look at it over the past 6 years. You look at it in its entirety, and it simply hasn't worked. And my fear is, now you're going to rebuild this. You're going to reset this. You're going to reset the quarterback. I think logically you're going to end up resetting the head coach. I'll dive more into that coming up in a minute. But you're not going to the general manager. And if the general manager goes out and he still has this ridiculous stuff about everybody around here getting all up in arms if he doesn't draft the right quarterback, I got news for you. We were up in arms because you brought in the wrong quarterback. Up in arms because Frank brought in his quarterback. Up in arms because you said years ago that Jacoby Brissett was a, what, top 10 quarterback or whatever it was, 15? Hell, it's been so long ago, I don't even remember the number. Yeah, all this stuff doesn't matter to me. All that matters is they haven't won a division title since 2014. And everybody else in this crapwater division has won two. They've got one playoff win over these 6 years. Two playoff appearances. That just isn't enough. So, nah, there's nothing personal here. There never will be, because I don't work that way. But I look back at that presser today, and he said everything that he felt he had to say, but it was all, to me, incredibly logical. And what he did in the process is he did win back a lot of you. Again, I'm not challenging the sincerity. But you have to. Who else are you going to blame? Who else are you going to blame? Frank's gone. Wentz is gone. And you can't blame the owner. You can't blame the owner for stepping in and doing something, forcing you to do something that you clearly did not want to do, and then clearly moving forward still don't want to do. And who knows? Maybe the owner makes you do it. But it is, to me, it is clear as day that a reset is necessary, because you're doing it all in all the major categories here. So why not there too? Why is there that belief here? Now, I will tell you this. I would offer you a counter argument. I would offer you that maybe there's nobody else in that building and maybe nobody else out there right now that they would trust any more than they have trust in Chris to go ahead and try to put something together. And that sounds terrible to say, but that may very well be true. That may very well be true. Now, I hope it's got nothing to do with the fact that Chris Ballard is still under contract in this case, the 2026 season. Because that'd shake me up a little bit. I wouldn't like that. And again, I know it's not my money. We're all really good at spending other people's money. I guess I'm chief among them right here. But you can't say we're going to do everything and we're going to do the absolute, all chips in, all this stuff that we commonly hear around here about what you're going to do for the football team and be worried about the finances. That's what I'm suggesting here. Yeah, this whole coaching stuff, do whatever you want to do, but make sure it's Jim Harbaugh. It sounds like that Jim Harbaugh would go ahead and bail Ann Arbor for the right price, then give him the right price. And I'm sure all these guys that you're going to bring in and talk to from, Aaron Glenn to Ben Johnson to blah, blah, blah. I'm sure they're going to be great one of these days. And who knows, maybe I can be wrong, but that's in this entire situation what I would trust. That is what I would trust moving forward. I would trust somebody to come in here and be the complete anti-Frank Reich. I would trust somebody to come in here that has been to a Super Bowl. I would trust somebody to come in into that has a definite tough attitude when clearly this organization needs it. And you bring somebody in here where the owner goes, all right, well, just go ahead and go about your business. I know it sounds ridiculous with Chris Ballard still there, but it doesn't sound any more ridiculous than Chris Ballard still being there. Does it? I'm not suggesting Jim Harbaugh at all is Vince Lombardi, but in this case, that seems like a really strong play here. See, Ray says, I'm sorry, in my opinion, you're wrong. Harbaugh sucks. I don't think he sucks at all. I think he's absolutely perfect for this situation. Perfect. Perfect. Who's more perfect? You tell me that. Who feels more perfect? Why do you not like Harbaugh? I'm curious. Why is that? It kind of seems like he fits the bill, especially if you're what, moving forward with a new quarterback? That fit. Seemed good to me. You're moving forward with somebody that everybody around here would trust. And again, I'll get into this argument a little bit later on. I didn't really mean to get into it. In the opening segment, was more about what Chris Ballard said today and whether or not you were a non-believer and you were brought back onto the bandwagon. That bandwagon of believability. I'm just not there. And again, there's nothing personal whatsoever. I'm not a name caller. I'm not going to get into that stuff. I'll treat people with the same amount of respect that they treat me. And I'm hoping that most of you are just like that. I know some of you are jackasses, but not all of you. Very small percentage of you deal in the jackassery. I get it. That's okay. Sometimes I respond, sometimes I don't. But this in the direction in which it's going just doesn't make a lot of sense to me in terms of the past and results and what we know. I just don't know what all is about to change because Chris also mentioned being hard-headed. I think he said dogmatic, which the first time I think I've ever heard that word, which is unsurprising. I mean, look where I'm from. I don't think too many people around Bloomfield saying, hey, I think that guy's very dogmatic. But that said, that's true. Does anybody out there believe that he's going to soften up in the category in which he believes? The grassroots in which he believes? That's like trying to change my mind that the 1980s aren't the best. Yeah, good luck. I just don't think his philosophy really is ever going to change. And you would argue, if it doesn't change and or adjust right now, will it ever? And the answer would be to me, no. That's why. And again, this whole failure or fail is not just about this year. This has been a stepping stone build outside of just trying to band-aid up the quarterback for years to get that type of team on the field that you want. And where we are in 6 years is with a 4-win embarrassing team. So that's where I stand on it. And that's probably not going to change anytime soon. We'll see. I tell you what, I will make you a deal. I will make you a deal. I will have, and I will own it and have a change of heart if Chris Ballard does. If Chris Ballard starts to adjust more to what and how teams win in this era, I will say, you know what? Everybody here that kind of fell into the okay, and I was done with him, but with that presser today, I'm all back on board. I'll own that. I'll own that. I'm a non-believer sitting here with you right now. It's going to be tough to talk me into it right now. It's one of those things where, and it's unfortunate, you got to see it to believe it. And we end up saying that. We've said that now for 2 years. That's what we said after last year in that debacle. Hey, you got to see this as a changed team. And not only were they not a changed team, they were worse than the product we saw in basically those final two games and certainly that final game in Jacksonville a year ago. To me, there is just a lot more not to believe about this setup moving forward than there is. Yeah, ultimately, though, the only vote that matters is the vote of the owner. But getting back to Chris Ballard today, he said everything that he had to say. He had to take that tact. He had to take that path. He had to come right out and say, you know what? I failed. I failed. And then everybody out there that heard that goes, oh, yeah, really? Okay, you did, right? But then where else are you going to go with it? It's like with JMV sucks. Hey, JMV sucks. All right. So what else are you going to say after that? I mean, how deep are you going to go? Everything is diffused. I mean, really, it was right out of the JMV sucks playbook right there. I was impressed with it. I failed. Yeah, JMV sucks. All the same category here. But I'm not going to challenge the sincerity because, again, he did handle that how you had to. I just am not on board as of right now. I will give it the benefit of the doubt if you go out there and you get what I think is necessary. And again, it's just my opinion. I'm assuming that all of you, much like Ray out there, does not agree with it. That's okay. That is okay. I just think Harbaugh is perfect for this right now. Harbaugh is what is necessary right now. I know he can be a little bit wacky, but I'll embrace a little bit of wackiness. He could take anything over what we have seen, what we have witnessed. But that would probably save it for me. And listen, I look at some of these guys. Look at some of the guys they bring in, they talk to. But I don't have a great deal of faith in anything right now moving forward because of what we have seen in the past. Because of the results of the past. And again, it wasn't just about this year. Chris Ballard is going to have a lot to prove out here, and there is nobody that knows that more than he does, and he's going to have plenty of time to do it. Because granted, he's going to go out, he's going to bring in a new coach, he's going to go out, he's going to draft a quarterback, and that's going to give him the remainder of his contract to play out here. And let's face it, by NFL standards, by the results in which he has given, that really doesn't equate, does it? That really doesn't make a lot of sense. A lot of other guys would have been bounced for much less. Or they have gone, the team would have gone a different direction for a lot less. And then as an end result, you have people asking us to believe in this thing who have told us to believe in this thing and have built this thing to where the only believable part of it is what we witnessed this year. See, that's kind of what you morph into. You morph into that now. It's going to take a lot to get away from that thought. How much good football is going to have to be played to get away from the stench that was this past year? And I don't care if it was Frank or if it was Jeff Saturday. But there's a lot you have to rebuild right here. You think Chris Ballard is going to create an all-new philosophy? No, okay, well, this didn't work, so let's go ahead and go this direction. Now I'm a believer in it. Again, that's something I don't buy, and that's something I don't buy until it's something that I end up seeing. But we'll get back to a lot of what was said in that press conference earlier today. I want to get your thoughts on that as well. I want to get your thoughts on where this thing is going. Your believability. A show of hands on how many believe that this should be the direction. Show of hands on how many believe that Jeff Saturday should be the direction. I know Chris Ballard changed a lot of minds today. I would just advise you to understand his situation. And not discredit him for what he said. Not call him a liar. Challenge his sincerity. But ask yourself, what else was he going to say? How else would he present that? By what other means would he frame that up? That's exactly what he had to do. And he's savvy at that. Don't get me wrong. He's very savvy. He can talk it up a little bit. I tell you, there are times, though, when he takes those long pauses, like here, I take some long pauses, and you guys all laugh about it. In this business, it's called a pregnant pause, but it's a long pause I take because sometimes I have to gulp some air down. My nose doesn't altogether work in terms of airflow. Because back in my 20s, no insurance, couple of broken noses. I just kind of let it be. Didn't really work out in my favor. But when he takes those long pauses, it's like he's thinking up a quick strategy here. And he is. He's thinking up a quick strategy. All right. And he went to the whole loaded question thing again today. The loaded question thing and then being worried about drafting a quarterback. I tell you what, worry about how we feel about your drafted quarterback when you stink and draft one. Or in a couple of years when that drafted quarterback is supposed to be better and is or isn't. I tell you what, when you draft him, if he is good, tell us I told you so. Do it. Do it. And the other aspect of it is on the quarterback, that's not been completely on him. The owner has had his hands in this too. But again, he's not going to blame the owner. That's not what you do whatsoever. So yeah, the appropriate tone is what Chris Ballard took today. But again, I would ask you, what else? What else was he going to say? How else was he going to put that to you? There was no other path. I certainly was not altogether down with the hiring of Jeff Saturday. Did you guys hear the quote? This is unprecedented, and we're putting him being Jeff Saturday, into a really tough situation here. And then Jim Irsay does that anyway. And those quarterback regrets, telling you that he would move up. So Ryan Poles runs the Bears, and he's going to have to, quote, be blown away. It's time for the Colts to be blowing somebody away here. Okay, blow some people away. Start blowing away. Easier said than done, JMV. You're sitting there. It's really easy for you. Blow somebody away. Blow somebody you know really well from the Kansas City years. Blow them away with something. An offer they can't refuse. Give yourselves all of the options with this. If you're so scared of making that pick and the type of reaction that's going to be had around here if that pick fails, which I hate that mentality, but if that's what you fear, make sure you give yourself the best odds. Blow them away. And then blow me away with the head coach. Change my tune altogether. Shut me up. We've got a lot of you out there saying, please, please shut this guy up. Shut him up. Shut him up in terms of that. Shut him up in terms of this franchise, this organization making decisions, all of the above. All right, 239-1070. Email address is JMV and 1075thefan.com. Inside the lounge via YouTube Live. A quick shout out if you guys are looking right now. This is the deliciously different t-shirt that is Big Red from Harley D and Nicole from my birthday last month. And they certainly know that this product, Big Red, of which I drank so much back in the 70s and the 80s, I worked myself into a kidney stone when I was 15, everybody. Shout out to Big Red. I love this t-shirt, though. I do. So thank you, Harley D and Nicole. And Harley D came out to Buffalo Wild Wings yesterday in Glendale and dropped this off. And I'm truly appreciative of that. We're thinking about Matt and Colton on this day as well. Friends of the show that come out all the time. And Colton and his operation. Thinking about Colton. Zach Keefer is going to join us coming up in the 4 o'clock hour. Greg Rakestraw is going to join us on the other side. No Ben Brown today because I want to keep this in large part with this conversation. This particular angle. And not even so much about the believability of Ballard today, but it's about the believability of Ballard in what is going to be a longer-term future now. This today may have changed some of your minds, maybe, but did it make it believable? Can this thing be turned around, or is the thought process like me going, yeah, I'm not buying it? And I know some of you suggest that he sounds like a con man when he talks. I'm not challenging anybody's sincerity because I don't want mine challenged. But there's no doubt he will talk a good game. He'll be savvy in talking a good game. Yeah, no doubt about that. All right, quick break, and we'll come back inside the lounge via YouTube Live, the stream, the app. It's HD Radio. And your calls, if you're on hold, if you're not, get there. 93.5-107.5 The Fan.
For adults with moderate to severe plaque psoriasis who are candidates for systemic or phototherapy, now there's Skyrizi, risankizumab riza, a prescription-only 150-milligram injection. With Skyrizi, 3 out of 4 people achieve 90% clear skin at 4 months, and Skyrizi is just 4 doses a year after 2 starter doses.
Nothing in me go hand in hand. Nothing on my skin, that's my new place.
Don't use if allergic to Skyrizi. Serious allergic reactions and an increased risk of infections or a lower ability to fight them may occur. Before treatment, your doctor should check for infection and tuberculosis. Tell your doctor if you have an infection or symptoms, such as fever, sweats, chills, muscle aches, or cough, or if you plan to or recently received a vaccine.
With Skyrizi, you could achieve 90% clearer skin. Ask your doctor about the number one dermatologist prescribed biologic in psoriasis and visit skyrizi.com or call 1-866-SKYRIZI to learn more.
Hey, John, if Randy at his best, Andy Moore Buick GMC. That's 131st State Road 37 in Fishers. Hey, talk to my friend Eric Wilson. Let Eric Wilson get you in the ride of your choice. Let me give you a bit of a heads up, though. The GMC Acadia with an elevation package is money. Seriously, what a great ride for you and the entire family. Great pricing right now. And the best service after the sale that you're going to get anywhere in the state of Indiana. One-stop shopping at one place. And tell Eric Wilson that I sent you and let he and his staff go to work on getting you that set of wheels of your choice. Just a great car buying experience at Andy Moore Buick GMC. 131st and State Road 37 in Fishers.
At Diamonds Direct, we want to make something very clear. We will absolutely beat the price of any comparable diamond that you find anywhere else. No fine print, no disclaimers, just a rock-solid, unqualified nationwide price guarantee. This goes for 1-carat diamonds as well as 15 and 20-carat diamonds. You see, at Diamonds Direct, we're more than just another jewelry store. We're part of a world diamond powerhouse with direct access to the world's top diamond mines. We have our own diamond cutters, too, so we are active in every aspect of the diamond market every single day, from source to showroom. So when you see a diamond somewhere else, online or in a store, or from some so-called supplier. Just know that apples for apples, you will get a better price at Diamonds Direct. Our volume, our connections, our buying power make this possible, and it's why we've never ever lost a sale due to price. So at a time when value means so much, we invite you to take this challenge and let us prove it. Day in and day out, you will always get a better quality diamond at a better price at Diamonds Direct. Diamonds Direct, your love, our passion. Online at DiamondsDirect.com.
Hey, it's JMV here from my friend Jason Gedham. That's Gedham Associates. It's 2023, right? So is it time for you to get that custom remodel? Let's get the wheels in motion for that right now, too. Get that custom remodel with the best Gedham Associates. So we're talking interior or exterior, kitchens, baths, screen porches, and more. I'm going to go that direction, and I want you to do that as well, because Gedham Associates, they have 35 years of experience serving Central Indiana. You are going to love it. You're going to love how they deal with you. You can check out their Google reviews as well to find out more. But I would advise you to check them out online right now. That's Gettem.com, Gettum.com. Tell them JMV sent you.
Dan Dockage for Affinity Whole Health. Affinity is the leader in testosterone and hormone replacement therapy, and I got to tell you, I see why. Since I started a testosterone replacement program with Affinity, my energy, mental focus, drive, everything is up, and the physical benefits are amazing. Check them out at feelgreatindy.com. Guys, you can improve the way you look, the way you feel. You can build muscle and lose fat. Affinity will give you the roadmap. Go to feelgreatindy.com. That's feelgreatindy.com.
JMV here for Heaven Hill Distillery and our Larceny Bourbon Locks and Luna Azul Tequila Shots. Every Thursday, me and our betting analyst, Brent Halverson, take a deep dive into the weekend that is going to be the NFL. We'll give you our picks, and we call them the Larceny Bourbon Locks and the Luna Azul Tequila Shots. This Thursday, join us for the free samples and all the fun that we have every single Thursday. Larceny Bourbon Locks and a Luna Azul Tequila Shots.
Playoffs are here. This week, join us at Pearl Street Pizzeria in Geist-on-Olio.
Hey, JMV, starting a new year can sometimes be overwhelming. Let Forum Credit Union help by giving you easy ways to save for all your financial needs in 2023. Whether you're looking for a high savings rate, want to be rewarded for regular weekly savings, or like the convenience of automating savings with every debit card purchase, Forum has great options to help you get ahead. Visit forumcu.com today or visit a branch location.
Everyone knows that in Indiana, game time...
Here's a deep three. Halliburton!
...means family time.
He's got family in Kokomo. That might have been from Howard County.
The Atlanta Hawks come to town this Friday for Lucas Oil Family Night. Family Night tickets start at just $20 and includes a Pacers hat, hot dog, chips, and small Pepsi product. Get your Family Night tickets at Pacers.com/family. That's Pacers.com/family. Pacers, Hawks, Friday at 7.
Be ready for snow at the mower shop and Fisher's with a gas or electric Toro snowblower and prepare for mowing season with discounts on select Spartan mowers. 317-849-9500 and themowershop.com.
It has no beginning.
The start of something special right here, man. Let's go.
And no end.
Look, you got to get your team ready to play.
It is a constant.
Get a rhythm going.
Through every season.
Come back again.
It is always cold season. Firing, hiring, free agency, the combine, the schedule, the draft, OTAs, minicamp, training camp, kickoff, the offseason.
Questions
is a season
to be answered for this Colts team.
The best Colts coverage is on 93.5 and 107.5 The Fan. The Ride with JMV.
Can I buy you guys a drink? Guess not.
93.5 and 107.5 The Fan.
I gotta grow. Like, I'm very stubborn and dogmatic sometimes. I do believe you have to be great up front. Like, I'll never, like, that's in my, that'll be on my grave. Like, you got to be good up front. And we weren't good enough this year. We showed signs, and I do think there's potential going forward, but we, at the end of the day, we weren't good enough, and that's on me. But in terms of how we build the rest of the roster, that's an area that we'll examine hard and move forward and grow.
So Chris Ballard earlier today, does that sound like a change in philosophy right there? Or does it sound like in terms of we verbally being grifted on that change in philosophy right there? I'm just curious. Didn't sound like much of a change in philosophy. It sounds like, you know, I really believe in this. I think we're getting better this year. And We'll see. If you're on hold, I'll get to you. Calls all day regarding the Ballard presser from earlier. Get your thoughts across the board, the coaching search, those that they're already going to bring in for an interview. And as Larry Bird once said, stuff I get. All coming up. Meantime, Andy Moore, Automotive Group Hotline, postgame show host, and he does everything else. He is Greg Rakestraw. Did that sound like a general manager that was ready to change a philosophy at all right there, or was that some words?
Well, time will tell. The proof will be in the pudding. And, you know, for this group, because of where they have drafted or not having had first-round picks to happy to get a quarterback, and again, I don't blame Chris Ballard for that. You know, we have frankly played more attention to what has happened in March than we have in April, as in, hey, free agency more so than the draft. Well, now once you're picking fourth and you're picking early in every round but the third, now it's more about April. So do I hope this group makes some moves in terms of free agency? Yes, but this is really the first time under Chris Ballard's watch since, say, 2018 that I'm going to pay far more attention to his draft class than I will any moves in free agency or lack thereof.
I say this, Ryan Poles in Chicago said, we need to be blown away. To me, it's time, and I know that you're only as good as what your offer is going to be compared to others here, probably of similar thought process. Don't you have to go to the absolute end and try to, quote, blow away the general manager of the Bears on this?
Now, I'm going to make a leap of faith into the JMV pop culture reference.
Yes.
So you check me to make sure that I am referencing the proper title to what I think is an early 90s classic.
Okay.
If Ryan Poles says he needs to be blown away, then you need to Nicole Eggert and Corey Haim the blank out of this, don't you?
Did yes, I make you do. Right yes, you there? Did. Don't give me the Tommy Lee Jones and Jeff Bridges one, man. Give me the two Coreys and Nicole Eggert. Works every time.
Corey and, yes. Exactly. Yeah, we all know the reason why it's a family show, and we'll simply leave it at that.
Exactly.
Again, if you think C.J. Stroud's your guy or Will Levis is your guy, and I don't know enough of the difference between now and April the 27th to give you an accurate assessment on that. If you say that that's one of your guys other than Bryce Young, you can probably sit pat at the four, but you've got to address the quarterback position. If you're of the camp of Bryce Young is your guy, the window is open to get to one, and whether it's picks or current player assets, you can move what you need to go get that guy. So
see, my thought process is this. I think if you like one of those top two, you got to get up there because they're both going to be gone. They're both going to be, because there's going to be another team that, to me, Chicago's not going to stand with that thing. They're going to get all they can get, and then that team that gets up there is going to be a quarterback team, and they're going to go with that particular quarterback.
Correct. And so I'm not even sure if getting to three get you what you need to. And let's state the obvious here. Houston is not making a deal within the division.
No.
You know, so you're not going to get the second pick. So to get the quarterback that you want, again, assuming that, and I'm not trying to speak for Chris Ballard here, but I think most have thought, hey, maybe, you know, Young over Stroud, but both are pretty good. And then Levis would be the next guy after that. If you think you want to get Bryce or CJ, you better be in the top two spots and you ain't getting the second pick.
Completely agree with that. And that's in terms of, you know, blowing them away. I think that's what you have to do. And I've also said this now, considering you're going to have Ballard, and you're not just going to have Ballard for this coming year. You're going to have him basically until the end of this contract now, because he's going to ride this thing along with the quarterback. And I'm assuming the head coach that he ends up selecting here. That's why, to me, let's just go ahead and go big there. I mean, to me, you offer up a ton of money to Jim Harbaugh, and he's going to leave Ann Arbor. For somebody's money, I think he's going to. And I think he's a perfect fit here. Am I wrong?
I don't think you are. What I would say is this. Any sort of issues in terms of spending money for this franchise has been because of the preference of the general manager, not because of the shortness of pockets of the owner. And so if, again, you think this is a change in philosophy, if actions match words from earlier today, then perhaps you're spending money on a head coach as well if you're the Indianapolis Colts.
Yeah, that's just my thought. If you're going to move forward with the way that it is, I think that's going to be it. And I guess we'd also challenge this. It ultimately all can be done by Jim Irsay, because whatever Jim Irsay says will happen. But if Chris Ballard is indeed going to pull that trigger on the decision for the head coach, it did not seem to me like the interim head coach, Jeff Saturday, is going to be given much of an opportunity. Again, unless the owner decides to step in and say, okay, that's who I want. You agree?
I guarantee you that Jeff will get the opportunity. Doesn't mean he's going to be the final one chosen, but I guarantee you he will get his opportunity. And perhaps it might be the best of the rest versus Jeff Saturday. Time will tell.
What do you think about the press conference in general, Greg, today from Chris Ballard?
I mean, there's never been an issue with Chris winning or losing press conferences. I tend to put more stock in this press conference because it's this, and not just today's, but the end of the season press conference, because that does give you an insight as to, okay, here is the path of the organization going forward. So much in the way of press conferences that are during the season are oftentimes dog and pony shows. You know, you've got what you see on the field that is far more important than what is said into a microphone at a podium. Now you get to this point, and your next game of any kind is 7 months away. Your next game that counts of any kind is 8 months away. Well, now all of a sudden, what the general manager has to say, to me, takes on a whole great deal of importance. So, to me, you can put more stock in what was said today. The most important thing about the press conference was who was having the press conference. So we can stop any discussion or debate. It's going to be Chris Ballard's job going forward. And now that question is set, now all attention can be on, okay, who is the next head coach? Is it Jeff Saturday, or is it one of the myriad of candidates that everybody will be talking about for the next couple of weeks?
I asked you a little bit earlier if you believed he was going to have a change in philosophy, as we had talked about, and you had mentioned only time will tell. Does this team, given the 4-win conclusion of this year, given the way that it looks, does it need a change in philosophy? Or is there any party that would argue that, well, if this or that goes better, then things would have been better? What's your argument there?
You are what your record says you are, and you've gotten to this point with a certain philosophy. And again, there are some circumstances that you've had to try to manage the quarterback position that I understand the logic behind every move, even if acknowledging the last two of them did not work. I understood that why the decision was made in March of 2021 and March of 2022, the way that it played out just didn't go as hoped or as expected. So I would say that, you know, when you have such a resounding thud of a season, it tells you adapt or die. You know, and that's a somewhat common phrase. I can literally hear, like, you know, Brad Pitt saying that in Moneyball. I think that's almost the conclusion now that is put in front of Chris Ballard. The other thing that I will say is this, again, was the offensive line play good enough? Hell no, it wasn't good enough. But yet I still look at that group and I go, it's not been that long ago that Braden Smith, Ryan Kelly, Quentin Nelson were all part of a really good offensive line. These are not guys, other than Ryan Kelly, who are in their 30s. There is still good football left. And I know, and I believe it was Football Outsiders or Pro Football Focus, I forget which one had it, that frankly, like, Ryman and Smith's numbers weren't that bad. You can question the schematics of how this team was coached up and play design and things like that. I do think the offensive line could potentially be fixed if you get the right person coaching them up, because I'm not sure that's been the case.
And the Chris Strasser, that was not approached today very much either, but again, there was a lot to go on in the time in which the Q&A was happening with Chris Ballard. Greg Rakestraw is on the Andy Moore Automotive Group Hotline. I guess my question is, with his level of stubbornness, I just can't imagine. And to answer your question, which wasn't so much a question but a thought that you had, these guys on this offensive line, they have to make a turnaround. Because you've got other things that are more absolute that you have to fix. You can't have something that you felt and then you extended and paid. You can't have that go haywire. There has to be a sense of truth to the reason why you gave them that money and believed in them. And that has to happen next year.
Absolutely right. And that's why I think everybody is on a one-year leash other than potentially the new coach. Everybody. Again, because of, you know, it's good news, bad news. Good news is you got some pieces in place. Part of the bad news is financially wise is the reason you have some of those pieces in place. Those guys simply put have to deliver in 2023, and it goes back to a Tony Dungy sign in the locker room that you've seen before. No excuses, no explanations. That has to be the answer. You have to get better play from the guys you are paying the most to on both sides of the football. A lot of those guys simply happen to reside along the offensive line.
Do you think Chris Ballard's on a one-year thing?
I don't think he'll be tied to the new quarterback. I don't think he'll be tied to the new head coach.
I think he's going
to
be here. I think he's going to be here until I retire.
And I'm not saying that, you know, this has to be a 10 to 12 win team for him to keep his job. If significant progress isn't shown from what you have seen this year to last year, again, remember the last time that there was a choice between general manager and coach, okay, the guy that wasn't given the axe lasted one more year. So just remember, there's precedent for that, even if it's going in the other direction.
It's Greg Rakestraw on the Andy Moore Automotive Group Hotline. Before I let you go, can this offense, especially through the air, can it be a quicker fix just by drafting a top-ranked quarterback over the, you know, the crusty noodleage arms that we have seen certainly this past year here? Is that what is necessary? Decision-making and throwing maybe helps right away, maybe more right away than what we're thinking right now?
Improvement along the offensive line helps everybody. The return of Jonathan Taylor helps everybody. A more mobile quarterback helps everybody. Get that quarterback one more weapon as well, if not more. Again, your first round pick has to be QB, but whether it's second round, whether it's free agency, you got to get more weapons, for this quarterback to throw to as well. And so, all of the things that we saw this year need to improve. But the idea is, if you draft a quarterback early in the first round, the thought is you're likely going to improve that position. If you get that quarterback more weapons to work with, you're also going to improve that position as well.
It's Greg Rakestraw with us via the Andy Moore Automotive Group Hotline. How long did you hang with that national title game last night?
I may have watched about 3 minutes of it. Last night was my only night of the week without any extra play-by-play. So I had dinner with a good friend of mine last night celebrating his birthday.
Nice.
By the time I got home at 9 o'clock, I was listening to the fan, listening to the game on the way home, and it was 17-7. Next time I flipped back over, it was 31-7. Next time I flipped back over, it was 58-7. I'm like, oh, dear God. So, it was pretty much friends reruns in the Rakestraw household.
The reason why I bring that up is I've made some quick judgments on Will Levis. Because a couple of games I've seen him play, I think one was against Georgia. He looked terrible. Whereas with C.J. Stroud, last time I saw him play, I thought he looked fantastic against that same Georgia team, that 62-7, the national title game against TCU last night. Thus, I like C.J. Stroud a great deal. I was curious if you have much of a recollection of watching Will Levis during better times than the couple of times we may have seen him this year?
No. No, and that's why I need to be doing more study. I can give you those names. I can't give you a lot of throws off the top of my head because of the various different things that I do. Usually on Saturday, if I'm not calling a college football game, I'm not watching a great amount of college football. So it's to the tape room for me between now and April the 27th.
Blown away. Got to blow them away. Got to blow them, just like the two Corys and Nicole Eggert. Yeah.
Maybe I'll watch that first. Maybe that's like the mood setter to then watch, you know, college football tape for the next 3 months.
There is nothing more disappointing when I am running through my movie choices on my DirecTV package and I get blown away. And then I click on it and it's Tommy Lee Jones and Jeff Bridges. I go, ah, man, come on.
I would assume you've got that on a grainy VHS tape that has like some wear marks from where you've rewound it over the years. You don't have that?
I don't think so. I've got some grainy VHS tapes, but I think they're much worse than that somewhere.
I also assume that you had like some sort of Skinamax for life card, given the references you've given them over the years.
I have had, I had the satellite dish, right? So I had American Triple Ecstasy. When I was in like a junior and senior in high school, I would just roll from like 6 p.m. at night until 6 a.m. in the morning. And then we'd take that and rent it. We could rent it out of the lockers at school back in the day. S-118, that's American Triple Ecstasy. It was a beautiful thing.
These are things only country folks know about, because this is how we got those. It was having those NASA-sized satellites in the front of your house. That's how you got more than three channels back in the day.
Got to go to the porn locker is right over there. Get your rentals today. All right. My friend, I appreciate your knowledge and your input and your insight. And thank you very much for the shirt. I rocked it yesterday. It's outstanding.
Good. I'm just glad I got to the proper size. Looked like it fit nicely.
I'm shrinking right now, man. I'm shrinking into great shape. Not really. I don't know.
Avoid shrinkage.
Yeah, well, that not so much, but yeah, all good. Thanks, brother.
See you, pal.
Greg Rakestraw on the Andy Moore Automotive Group hotline. Plenty of time for you. Here's what I got. I got some freedom coming up after this break. Get some freedom in the 4 o'clock hour. We can all revisit and get your thoughts, because you matter. You are the viewing public. You are these folks that go out and you buy tickets and you got the disposable income. I'm curious your thoughts on Chris Ballard today. If you were a non-believer after the season, did you transform into a believer after today's press conference, or do you remain the same? 239-1070. Those phone calls, if you're on hold, we'll come at you next.
The Butler Bulldogs host Villanova this Friday in Creighton on Tuesday the 17th. 7 p.m. tip-off both nights. Visit butlersports.com/buy tickets and get to Hinkle for Big East play.
My husband and I live next door to a haunted graveyard. It's a little creepy, but we manage. Just like we manage without home internet. Do I wish my mobile hotspot was faster? Yes, but I make it work. Kinda. Just like we make it work sleeping next to a 17th century burial ground.
Honey, can you move your hand?
That's not my hand.
It's mine.
Not having home internet? It's not that bad. Grab my hand.
Wait, okay.
No, not up the stairs. We tried that last time. No. Run away. You can literally run through him.
Don't settle. Switch to Xfinity and get one line of unlimited mobile and home internet together for $50 a month for 12 months. Go to Xfinity.com, call 1-800-XFINITY, or visit your local Xfinity store today. Restrictions apply. Requires new Connect internet service with one-year contract. Auto pay and paperless billing with stored bank account. Equipment, taxes, and fees extra. Reduce speeds after 20 gigabytes of data usage. Offer ends 3/21/23.
Hey, everybody. We've all heard stories from friends and family about something really bad that happened. You're in an accident. There's a painful life-altering injury, huge medical bills, even wrongful death at all from someone else's fault. In fact, some of you might be dealing with that right now, and that's where the attorneys at Paul Ritchie Law Firm can help. It's Tony Patterson, Paul Cruz, and John McLaughlin lead a team with over 70 years of collective courtroom experience and millions of dollars in jury awards and settlements for their clients. Now, none of us can change the past. Just know that Tony, Paul, and John are on your side to help you and your family going forward. They're recognized by Super Lawyers and U.S. News and World Report as being among the leading injury lawyers in Indiana, so even if you're unsure you have a case, give Paul Ritchie a call. They're going to listen and give you their free experienced legal opinion. That number's 317-269-2509, or visit parinjury.com, parinjury.com.
People who suffer from arthritis are getting real pain relief with exciting biologic therapies at QC Kinetics.
The success rate is there, and there's no better way to treat yourself when it comes to dealing with pain.
Meet Tyler Vail, co-founder of QC Kinetics, who says they can't cure arthritis, but they can treat the pain.
If you think of the tide coming in and out on the beach and what it does, it erodes the sand, right? It can't stop the tide, but eventually when the sand or the beach gets bad enough, we backfill that beach with sand so that we get generations of enjoyment with that beach again. And the same thing happens with your knee or your shoulder or your hip or your back. We want to backfill the problems that have happened to this point. I'm not stopping the tide, so I'm not stopping the arthritis, but I want to get generations of enjoyment out of those joints again.
Call QC Kinetics now for your free consultation. Learn more about how restorative biologic therapies can get you real and lasting joint pain relief.
Call QC Kinetics 317-559-PAIN. That's 317-559-PAIN. 317-559-PAIN.
Join Mark Patrick's seminars and lose the weight guaranteed, only $49.99. Also, stop smoking with Mark Patrick. This hypnosis is designed to destroy your desire to smoke without cravings, irritability, weight gain, or your money back. Seminars Thursday, January 19th at the Holiday Inn Express and Suites in Noblesville. Weight loss 5:30 p.m. Stop smoking 8 p.m. And Saturday, January 21st at the Holiday Inn Indianapolis Airport. Weight loss 11 a.m. Stop smoking 2 p.m. Register at markpatrickseminars.com.
Guys, the party tonight is at Dancer Show Club on West Washington Street. Dancers is Indy's premier gentlemen's club. It's just minutes from downtown, the airport, and the track, so you're never far from the action. Three main stages, the most entertainers, sports on the big screens, bottle service, weekly specials on food and drink, and 8,000 square feet of fun. Bachelor parties, divorce parties, birthday parties, whatever the occasion, the party is at Dancer Show Club. Open till 3 a.m. 7 days a week. DancerShowClub.com.
The Pacers head to the Big Apple to face the New York Knicks tomorrow night at 7 on 93.5 and 107.5 The Fan.
The Ride with JMV.
I fart in your general direction. Your mother was a hamster and your father smelt of elderberry.
93.5 and 107.5 The Fan.
Greg Rakestraw podcast 107.5thefan.com. JMC, this is from Steve Sharp. Let's see if you can figure out the type of numbnut Steve Sharp is. Just by JMC, kind of go, okay, whatever. If you weren't aware, a coach has to want a job. The fact you're wasting time talking about Harbaugh shows you, like the rest of you media guys, are clueless. Give us one valid reason Harbaugh would genuinely listen to this clown show organization, because he knows the owner, because he has played here, because he wouldn't mind to get back in, because he's had roots here before, and because they pay him an ass load of money. I think I just gave you five reasons, Sharpie. You want any more? Adam's at 239-1070. Hello, Adam. How are you?
Hey, JMV, thank you for taking my call. I want to go in a different scenario situation here. I believe the Bears have the number one pick, right?
They do.
So if we go after Justin Fields for a quarterback and do some type of a trade, wouldn't that attract more predominant coaches for the future?
Well, that's not going to happen. Ryan Poles has already said, their general manager, that they are going to be riding with Justin Fields anyway. But yeah, they're going to just hold that pick up for ransom, knowing that somebody's going to want to get up there and have their pick of this quarterback class.
Okay, so I guess the best alternative would be possibly Bennett as our quarterback.
What? Stetson Bennett, I like a great deal. Like what? A stay quarterback for the future? Stetson Bennett?
Yeah, I mean, we're not going to get the overall number one pick.
You're going to, and Adam, hey, you call anytime, Adam. Thank you very much. I got to hit the top of the hour break. To me, sitting here right now, before I know anything else, it is C.J. Stroud, it is C.J. Stroud, it is C.J. Stroud. I don't give a damn about Ohio State's history of not producing high-level NFL quarterbacks. None of that bothers me whatsoever. And I love what I watched when he played Georgia. Loved it. And I just want this Colts team to get up, to do their best to get up, and to have their pick. And not have to rely. Adam, thank you. Quick break. I'm going to go ahead and reset with everybody here. I'm going to have at least 30 before Zach Keefer coming up at 4:30. I will get to everybody on hold. Chris Ballard with the media today. More reaction to that. Hour 2 at 239-1070. Straight ahead next.
It has no beginning.
The start of something special right here, man. Let's go.
And no end.
Look, you got to get your team ready to play.
It is a constant.
Get a rhythm going.
Through every season.
Come back again.
It is always Colts season. Firing, hiring, free agency, the combine, the schedule, the draft, OTAs, minicamp, training camp, kickoff, the off season. Questions is a season to be answered for this Colts team. The best Colts coverage is on 93.5 and 107.5 The Fan.
Are you dealing with foot, knee, hip, or back pain? We can help. Hi, this is Phoebe with the Good Feet Store, and I want to talk about your discomfort. Did you know that your feet have a quarter of all the bones in your whole body? With four arches, 33 joints, and over 100 ligaments and tendons in each foot, it's no wonder so many people suffer from foot, knee, hip, and back pain. Stop throwing your money away on all those over-the-counter products and expensive shoes that just can't do what the Good Feet Store can. At America's Arch Support Store, we teach you everything you need to know about how our patented three-step system will work to solve your problems so you can get back to living the life you love without your pain getting in the way. Come in today for your free personalized fitting and test walk and trade in those bad feet for some good feet. Don't just live with the pain. Discover your options at the Good Feet Store. We're in Fishers and Greenwood. Call 829-1040 or visit goodfeet.com to make your appointment today. Get back to doing what you love with arch supports from the Good Feet Store.
Hey, Johnny, I got to make sure that you're warm and comfortable in your home, as the winter temperatures at some point here are going to take a nosedive, right? So you got to make sure your heating system, your heating unit is doing its job. And that's where you call my friends, John and Chris Love at Love Heating and Air, 317-353-2141, to make sure you are good to go for the entirety of the winter. You don't want to have any breakdowns. You don't want to have to think about maybe your system's not up for this winter. Be sure. Have that peace of mind with Love Heating and Air, 317-353-2141, online, love-hvac.com today.
You've undoubtedly heard of the calm before the storm. Well, Michaelis is the calm after the storm. More than three decades of restoring damage from wind, rain, and hail. They've got your back, not to mention your front, side, and roof. It's why home and business owners beat a path to Michaelis' door. Because it's always answered around the clock with welcome arms. Your port in the storm. From site security and tarping services to complete restoration work, they can handle anything Mother Nature throws your way. Seasoned and trustworthy pros who are never deterred by a little wind and rain, or a motherload of it for that matter. Water, storms, fire, and foundations. Life happens. Michaelis happens to help you through it. Call 844-FIX-INDY. Make it Michaelis.
Hey, fellas, need an annual health exam for work, or you just want to prioritize your health this year? I recommend Low T Center to get your complete health assessment. They check all your levels, not just testosterone, and typically completely covered by most health insurance. And if you're not insured, it's less than $100 for full labs and an office visit with a provider. Low T Center specializes in men's health, making it quick and easy. That's lowtcenter.com to book your appointment online. Low T Center, reinventing men's health care.
Home shows provide homeowners the deepest discounts of the year on remodeling projects. And right now, Window Nation is bringing home show savings right into your home. Schedule a free, no obligation, in-home demonstration today and lock in this incredible offer. Get two free windows with every two you buy with no limit. Plus, pay no interest for 60 months. Imagine the savings in cost and lower energy bills, but you don't just have to imagine how beautiful new Window Nation windows will look on your home. You can see it. Use their free virtual visualizer at windownation.com/homeshow. Upload a picture of your house and try out hundreds of options online. Get design tips from the experts and learn how Window Nation's trained installation specialists have helped over 150,000 homes with over 96% satisfaction. But remember, these once a year home show savings are for a very limited time. Call Window Nation today at 866-90-NATION or go to windownation.com/homeshow. Get two windows free with every two you buy. Pay no interest for 60 months. That's five full years. 866-90-NATION or go to windownation.com/homeshow.
Hello there. My name is Seychelle, and what makes the Chick-fil-A chicken sandwich original to me is the punch of flavors that's unlike any other. You get the crispy tenderness of the chicken and that hint of sourness from the pickles. Ta-da!
Hey, I'm Juan, and what makes the Chick-fil-A chicken sandwich original to me is you know you're going to get chicken that's crispy, golden, and juicy. This is the gold standard of chicken sandwiches.
Order the original Chick-fil-A chicken sandwich on the Chick-fil-A app today. Real customers paid for their testimonials.
93.5 and 107.5, The Fan.
WIBC HD2, W298BB, WIBC HD3, W228CX, Indianapolis.
The Pacers head to the Big Apple to face the New York Knicks tomorrow night at 7 on 93.5 and 107.5 The Fan.
The Ride with JMV. .95 and 107.5 The Fan.
Look, I failed. I'm not going to sit up here and make excuses. Failed a lot of people. Highly disappointed, you know, about where we're at, how the season went. You know, I never take lightly what's at stake here. It's not, you know, the wins and losses, but, you know, people's lives are on the line. Players' families, coaches' families, front office, people in this building, and I don't ever take that lightly. You know, I'm disappointed. I'm disappointed where we're at, and ultimately, it falls on my shoulders.
It's Chris Ballard earlier today from his press conference at the lead of the coaching search. Hour two of this show, thank you very much for joining us. We've got a lot of calls on hold to get to as well. That Zach Keefer, bottom of the hour, then more coming up in the 5 o'clock hour. You know, Casey in Ellettsville and I believe the same thing regarding Chris Ballard today. JMV at 107.5thefan.com is the email address, and Casey writes this. A lot of people are mistaking honesty for accountability where Ballard is concerned. When he says he failed, that's honesty. Taking accountability would mean showing a willingness to change his philosophy to avoid making the same mistakes that led to that failure. Ballard hasn't shown the willingness up to this point to do so, and that's what I mentioned to Greg Rakestraw. I asked him if he felt he was going to have that change in philosophy. You can make the argument, well, he's drafted wide receivers and done this. But the blueprint that he had and he built, that's what failed. And it wasn't just in this year. It has been a failure over the better part of 6 years. But Casey, that is absolutely positively accurate. And that's why I'm not going to question his sincerity. That's not at all what I'm doing. But what is he going to be moving forward here? What's going to change? Is it going to change when they just draft a quarterback, a longer-term quarterback? I have said through 6 years, to me, I've seen enough. My vote doesn't matter. The owner's vote does. He hasn't. Now, I would disagree with what Greg said last hour. Greg thought that maybe most of these guys, with the exception of the head coach, are going to be on the one-year program moving forward. I just don't know about that. I think once Ballard makes this hire, or along with Jim Irsay, makes this hire, and then they end up drafting a quarterback, it's going to be 2023, 2024. And since he's on contract through 2026, probably 2025, I think he's going to be here as long as we're all going to be here. Most of the time in the NFL, if you show results, as we've seen in the past 6 years, you don't get that opportunity. You don't get that longevity. All right, 239-1070. At the top of the list, we'll start with Rick today. Rick, welcome to the show. How are you? Hello, Rick.
Yes.
Go ahead, Rick.
Oh, it's not Rick, it's Chris.
Chris. Hello, Chris. No wonder you didn't answer when I called you Rick.
No, it's the president of the 33 fan club right here.
You got that, Chris. We're right. Yeah, you know, it feels great, doesn't it? Does it not feel great really to be a winner? We're winners.
We are winners. That is fantastic. But to go back to the Colts, I'm with you. We've seen enough of Ballard. I didn't get to watch the press conference today. I was at work all day. But we saw the press conference at the beginning of the year. We saw him telling us, oh, we're good with the guys we got. We're going to be a contender. We're going to be this. We're going to be great. It was just blowing smoke up our butts. The dude, he's got to go. He's got to go.
I just think six years, even with, you know, that whole fiasco and the chaos with Andrew Luck, I think 6 years is enough to show, to me, infinitely more than what we have seen. So that's been, that has been my rationale And obviously, and nothing personal or axe to grind here. It's just been the results. And even Chris mentioned that earlier today. He said, I completely understand the criticism here. Although, I think he was alluding to more of just this year than the overall body of work. And I'm more about the overall body of work.
Exactly. And then to go to our draft picks, everybody's talking about Stroud or Young. But if you remember, when we drafted Peyton Manning, everybody was talking about Ryan Leaf, not Peyton Manning. So it's not about the guy that's supposed to be drafted first or the guy that's supposed to be drafted highest. You need to go look at all the tape and draft the guy that's going to fit and win. You need to go draft a winner. Why are we not talking about Max Duggan or Stenson Bennett? I know Max had a really bad game, a really, really bad game. But we need to go look at the winner. Not just the guys we're supposed to draft because they're supposed to be the best quarterback.
Hey, Chris, thank you very much for the phone call. Shout out to 33. I happen to think that Bryce Young and C.J. Stroud are winners. The stuff that doesn't matter to me about either one of those quarterbacks, for example, is the height situation with Young. I don't care. Or the quarterback history of Ohio State. Not showing up dramatically on the NFL level. I don't care. I just care about those guys. I think those guys are at the top of the class, and I believe that is absolutely where the Colts need to be. Am I shortchanging Will Levis? Sure. Am I shortchanging a guy like Stetson Bennett? Absolutely. Stetson Bennett in the past 2 years has just been through the roof with incredible accomplishments. But as far as being an NFL starting quarterback for the Colts, I'll go ahead and let somebody else take that shot. He'll probably get a shot to do something, but that's not it. To me, it's going to be one of these two dudes that you have to find a way to get. And there are a lot of excuses, and you can poke holes in a lot of these arguments. I mean, hell, you can poke holes in mine if you want. Well, you watch C.J. Stroud. I watched him more than one game, but the one game that really impressed me was that Georgia game. You watched Georgia last night? The way that they de-pants TCU? You watched the way that Stroud played against Georgia? I know that their defense lost, a handful of dudes to the NFL as draft selections a year ago, but that is still, by far, as we witnessed last night, the most talented team in college football. And I look at C.J. Stroud with that test against them in that semifinal, even in a loss, as passing an incredible test. Thank you, Chris, for that. Mark's up next at 239-1070. Mark, welcome to the show.
Hey, thanks, JMV.
You got it, bud. Go ahead.
Hey, I think you're right about Chris Ballard being here long-term, unfortunately. I'd love to see him gone. I mean, not that I like to see anybody fired, but I just don't think he's been doing what he needs to do. But I don't see – I mean, if you bring in a new coach and draft a young quarterback, I mean, you just expect to give them the time. And I don't know how you distinguish them from
exactly.
Chris Ballard.
Yeah, me too. And, I'm right there with you, yes.
And then as far as his press conference is concerned, not that he said really surprised me, I don't suppose. I know some people are up in arms about him not throwing Saturday under the bus and then not just hemming himself in with a quarterback. I didn't really expect him to do either one of those things either. I did think his press conference was better than what Saturday said yesterday. I mean,
Saturday is more of a, this is what was going on around me and this is why we were bad. Yeah, I mean, in Ballard had, and that's, Ballard was pointing to this 1 year on him. I point more to the past 6 years in total, maybe not so much the early stages, but the past 6 years of the body of work in all. And, Jeff, he was more accountable than what Jeff was talking about yesterday, without question.
Oh, yeah. And Jeff, he was saying it was his opinion that the team was closer than what everyone else thought. I mean, it's not my opinion. I mean, we're drafting fourth in the NFL draft for a reason. I don't see how you can say that we're that much closer. But.
Yeah, well, and again, I would tend to agree with that. And then some will have the argument of, one, the division in which you play in and how that played out this season. to get Jacksonville that division title, and the other would be those that suggest that if you just had a quarterback with just any ability whatsoever this year, that some of these circumstances could not have been the same. And I'm not talking about, obviously, you know, the second half against Minnesota, the fourth quarter against Dallas, or certainly what has happened down the stretch and these debacle games they played in and lost. But having a competent quarterback with arm strength, you know, with escapability, all that, people would think that you could see a quicker turnaround with this offense if it's healthy and this offensive line protecting. That's not necessarily my argument, but that's certainly an argument to be made for a quicker turnaround, if that makes sense.
Yeah. And one last thing just about Harbaugh. I'm just curious about your response. Yeah. I have been on the Harbaugh train, except for it seems like lately with the accusations and then him trying to get Panthers to talk to him, it seems like it's been kind of a circus around him lately, and so that makes me a little bit nervous, but I didn't know what your thoughts were about that.
Yeah, that's going to come with some wackiness, and thank you, Mark, for the call. I mean, he brings some wackiness here, but I think he brings a level, he brings certainly a level of accountability, which I think everybody wants. He certainly has been to a Super Bowl. You look at the results he's had in the past. I just don't see a lot of reasons, and I'm not suggesting at all that it's going to happen. I know that it's a long shot, but, you know, if you're talking about, yeah, I hate this term too, the whole swinging for the fences thing, this is, to me, this is the coach that you swing for. This is the coach I like above all else, and you know what? If that fails, we'll reevaluate Ben Johnson and Aaron Glenn and D'Amico Ryans and whomever else they end up bringing in. But this is who I like right now for this organization, the way this organization looks, and the way this organization has been run by its owner. I think he is a perfect complement for all that we have seen, bringing in a new quarterback. You know, the softness that Frank became accustomed to, the looseness in which he presided as the head coach, that stops. The comfort level with the owner to be able to back away and trust who's making the decisions, thus let those that he put in charge of this team run the team. Yeah, that's even before you get on to the success he's had in the past on the field. Yeah, everything else, I mean, I can bring up, well, if you're Michigan, you watch Georgia, you've made it to the finals the past 2 years, the final four, if you will, the college football semifinals. But, man, everything's still going to run through the SEC. Yeah, those are really bad ways of me trying to talk myself into it, but I do, if that is at the top of the list, or if there is a list, I think that should be at the top of the list. That's just me. I'm not suggesting whatsoever that can be accomplished. But that's at the top of my list. Tom is up next. Tom, welcome to the show. Hello, Tom. I'm here with you. Go ahead.
Oh, hi. Hey, I watched the Dan Patrick show today, and he had Tom Pelissero on.
Yeah.
And he's asking him about Harbaugh, and they're talking about Denver. And then he said, what about Indy? And Pelissero says, well, Jeff Saturday's a very serious candidate there.
He's right about that.
Jim is a big fan, so he's staying away from Indy.
I don't know that to be the case, but that very well could be the case. But the first part is highly accurate. He is a big candidate, and that, to me, it doesn't even matter what Chris Ballard thinks about it. It's what the owner thinks about it. And that's where the owner slots in Jeff Saturday as a serious candidate. He's going to be a serious candidate.
The rest of this, you know, interviewing these other guys is kind of a facade.
Well, and, I mean, certainly there's protocol involved here. Don't get me wrong with that. But, yes, there is no doubt when others have had doubt in whether or not Jeff Saturday is going to get a serious look here beyond this interim basis, he absolutely is, because that is coming from the owner. The owner's going to give him that.
Yeah, for sure. So it'll be interesting to see what develops.
You got it. Tom, thank you for the call.
Okay.
That's Eric is up next at 239-1070. Eric, welcome to the show.
Hey, thanks for having me on.
You got it.
I just want to say I agree with you 100% about Ballard.
When he got here, he took over an 8-8 team. Within a year, he had expiring contracts. He had plenty of draft picks. He had plenty of cap space. And he has brought in his guys repeatedly year after year after year. And they've underwhelmed. I mean, this guy wanted McDaniels as a head coach. He wanted Matt Rhule as a head coach. Bad decisions. He traded for Carson Wentz. He traded for Matt Ryan. Bad decisions. And I don't want to run through cliches, but the Leopard does not change his spots. He is who he's been. And he's not going to wake up tomorrow and all of a sudden start making wise decisions where he has not done that over the past 6 years. One playoff game in 6 years is not enough.
Thank you. Yep. Eric, thank you for the call. 4-12, 10-6, 7-9, 11-5, 9-8, 4-12-1. One playoff win, a couple of playoff appearances, and that is the basis of my thought is those are the results. And that's even given the benefit of the doubt for some things. The benefit of the doubt, for example, to the Andrew Luck decision. Certainly we're well past that right now. And knowing that he has been force-fed a quarterback. But at the same time, this looked to me like the end of something that simply was not going to work. Alas, it is not. And that's where we're going to be moving forward. Ray's up next at 239-1070. Ray, welcome to the show.
Hey, JMV.
Hello, Ray.
I'm not in the 33 club. I'm sorry to tell you, good player, but I'm not going to jump into that.
Ray, why are you not in the 33 club? I don't know if we can be friends.
You know what, JMV? I don't have a problem with Turner. It's just I feel like you got to get what you can get for him. I don't think he's going to.
Don't you? Would you rather get what you can get out of him?
Yeah,
like what you're getting right now to complement the rest of this team? Wouldn't you rather have that than think about what you're going to get for him? I mean, it seems like that Indy's always had, we always get stuck with assets and, trade value and all this crap. I mean, doesn't it make you feel good to see what you're getting out of him right now and how he is flourishing with this group that is going to be the long-term solution to playing deeper into the postseason and having success at the NBA level? Wouldn't you rather have that?
You know what, JMV? I bought into the we're rebuilding with the Pacers. So I think that's where my train of thought comes from when I say you got to get what you can get for them. Because I'm still in the mindset. I'm surprised by where the Pacers are this season. But I'm still in that rebuilding mindset and getting draft capital or trading for young pieces. So I'm still in that mindset.
Yeah, Ray, my friend, you can't. You've got to be able and be willing to adjust. We sit through around here way too much crap and wait on what we believe is going to be this grand vision coming true. And when you get lightning in a bottle and somebody is ahead of schedule, you got to jump on that train and ride it, man. You just do. And I would do that right now. If things change and they go on the tank and all this has been fool's gold, then so be it. But, man, I think we've been seeing this team play long enough this year against good teams to know that what we have seen to this point is legit. And you're just watching this team evolve quicker than what anybody, including the team and including the head coach, Rick Carlisle, thought. Man, you got to ride that thing. Ride this horse until it bucks you, brother.
You're right about it. But let's get to the coach.
You go ahead.
Before, I thought Ballard may have needed to go. But after today, I think he needs to stay. I think he's a good talent evaluator, as they say. So I think it's crucial that you have him leading the charge to find that next quarterback, because he has to get it right. He just has to, because if he doesn't, we're talking about something that's going to set us back even further, about three to four more years. So I think you can't have someone new coming in, try to change everything. And I think it's just not a good recipe.
I think you're going to have a new quarterback. Well, you're going to have a new quarterback. You're going to have a new coach. I want to get all these guys on a similar plane, a similar timeline. That would make a lot of sense to me. Now, I will say, I say one thing to you, Ray, in agreement with you, is maybe that there's not a sense of confidence that if you bring somebody else in right now, they can accomplish those two previous items that I mentioned. Maybe it's just too overwhelming. Oh, you know what? Chris is already here in pocket, so you got to roll with it because you can't bring anybody in right now and still start the ball rolling to get those other two major assets that you want. I just I don't happen to believe that. I think that you can. I think you start everybody in this case at the top of your organization on your team. I think you all start them on the same timeline, but that's not going
to
be the case.
Let me bring up a name to you, JMV. What about Howie Roseman? How they let go of Peterson and Wentz, and he stayed on as GM, and they brought in Sirianni and Hurts. So I mean, it's a recipe that can be effective.
Oh, no, and listen, if this, I already said earlier, I would love to see him if he's going to be here longer term, which clearly he is. Prove me wrong. You know, prove this evaluation that I've had over 6 years wrong. You know, prove me wrong. But I just, right now, sitting here, I don't see it. You know, maybe you do get something like, maybe you do end up getting a guy like Nick Sirianni and you know, draft in the second round Jalen Hurts and he turns into something special and you know, out with the old, in with the new, whatever. But it's just been 6 years of results in which I'm basing my opinion on Chris Ballard on. Nothing more.
Yeah, and I agree with you. But I just say let's hold out a little more hope.
Ray, thank you. You got to thank you for the call. Yeah, and going back to the Pacer thing, man, it is okay to embrace something. You don't always have to wait around for assets. God, everybody, and it seems like, and I don't know what age Ray was, but it seems like, man, all these young dudes, we got to wait around, and hey, we got to go ahead and get some draft capital. I don't know how much time I have. I got to expedite this process a little bit. I've been all too familiar over these recent years of losing, of sucking, of having to be negative day after day. I can't lie to you. Coming on here and throwing a lot of love at the blue and gold makes this guy sitting here 3-6 feel really good. Because you just get overwhelmed by negativity. I tell this to my mom all the time, too, before the break. Quick story. She sits around and watches all these news programs. And I say, hey, you know, you got to get away from that. Is there anything else you can watch? I mean, soap operas or what? Get away from that because that ends up polluting you. It clogs your mind. Get away from it a little bit. That's what negativity does, man. Negativity locks you up like a big block of cheese for dinner. I really have enjoyed talking about the Pacers in this light this year. It makes me feel good because we have been just involved, just overwhelmed by so much negativity. It feels really good. Quick break, we'll come back. I see Todd Marcellus, John and Jay, and Zach Keefer. That and more coming up next.
My partners had told me I should get my knee replaced. I was in my 40s, and I decided that I wouldn't do that.
That's orthopedic surgeon Dr. John Herzog, who found regenerative medicine years ago and became a believer.
It changed my life around. It improved me to a point where I was able to jog again.
That's when Dr. Herzog switched his focus from surgery to helping his patients with natural biologics.
I've treated at least 5,000 patients. I believe your body has everything it needs to heal itself.
Today, you'll find Dr. Herzog at QC Kinetics, the nation's leader in this exciting field of medicine that can give lasting pain relief with no downtime, no drugs, and no surgery.
I have patients coming up to me that I did 10 years ago saying, you know, doc, my elbow's still working great. I'm playing tennis 3 days a week.
Call QC Kinetics now to explore alternative ways to deal with your pain. It's a free consultation.
Call QC Kinetics, 317-559-PAIN. That's 317-559-PAIN. 317-559-PAIN. Pain.
Hey, I love pickup basketball. It has become increasingly more difficult for us hoopers out there to find some game. You know what, though? In Noblesville, I've got a spot for you. Pickup USA Fitness. It's a better way to play. Huge gymnasium. Every single night they have pickup games, including Saturday morning. And after 6 o'clock, these things are reffed up. You don't have to worry about it. You don't have to stop for 5 minutes and argue with some clown trying to call a charge on you or 3 seconds. Nah, It's great. You'll love it. It's Pickup USA Fitness in Noblesville. They also have men's league nights as well. And I'm telling you, all ages can develop their skill, especially to the younger generation. They can develop their skill at Pickup USA Fitness in Noblesville. Hey, call Scott today, 317-316-5770. Get that membership going. PickupUSAFitness.com. That's Pickup USA Fitness in Noblesville, a better way to play.
When you hear Diamonds Direct, it's not just a catchy name designed to give the illusion of value. Our name is who we really are. Diamonds Direct was started by diamond cutters a quarter of a century ago. At our very core is a commitment to cut out the middleman and deliver extreme value in exquisite diamonds. Today, that's more true than ever with our direct access to diamonds straight from the mines. Diamonds that we then cut and polish. Exquisite diamonds up to 15 and 20 carats in all shapes and sizes. It's an advantage other jewelers only dream of. By overseeing the entire process, we know for a fact Diamonds Direct is truly direct. So this year, as value becomes more important than ever, rest assured that Diamonds Direct's unique status in the world diamond market guarantees you the best no-middleman direct importer price, period. And even with this extreme value promise, at Diamonds Direct you still get an unbeatable selection, transparent education, a luxurious shopping experience, superior customer service, no compromises. It's not having a cool name or clever advertising, it's the truth. Diamonds Direct, your love, our passion.
On the podcast, Hey Dude, the 90s Called, David Lasher and Christine Taylor, stars of the cult classic show, Hey Dude, bring you back to the days of slip dresses and choker necklaces.
We're going to use Hey Dude as our jumping off point, but we are going to unpack and dive back into the decade of the 90s.
We lived it, and now we're calling on all of our friends to come back and relive it.
So leave a code on your best friend's beeper, because you'll want to be there when the nostalgia starts flowing. Listen to Hey Dude, the 90s Called, wherever you get your podcasts.
Man, I do that every single Saturday night right next door on B, right here, right now. Hey, speaking of right here and right now, L.D. Smith Plumbing, the best in local plumbing. That's Lance and his local team at 317-927-7186. This is the time of year, not right now, but when we get colder, that your pipes can freeze, and that will leave you with a plumbing emergency. And Lance and his local team always have your back. And I want you to make sure you remember the number. You write it down someplace to have it for later. 317-927-7186. The best for all your plumbing needs, Lance and his local team at LD Smith Plumbing online, ldsmithplumbing.com today.
Hey, JMV, starting a new year can sometimes be overwhelming. Let Forum Credit Union help by giving you easy ways to save for all your financial needs in 2023. Whether you're looking for a high savings rate, want to be rewarded for regular weekly savings, or like the convenience of automating savings with every debit card purchase, Forum has great options to help you get ahead. Visit forumcu.com today or visit a branch location.
Open enrollment for health insurance is underway and ends January 15th. Eskenazi Health understands this can be a confusing process. That's why Eskenazi Health is here for you, to assist you in understanding your health insurance options and also help with questions surrounding Medicaid eligibility under the COVID-19 public health emergency, which may end soon. Simply go to eskenazihealth.edu or call 1-855-202-1053 to request your telehealth appointment or to get more information.
JMV here for Heaven Hill Distillery and our Larceny Bourbon Locks and Luna Azul Tequila Shots. Every Thursday, me and our betting analyst, Brent Halverson, take a deep dive into the weekend that is going to be the NFL. We'll give you our picks, and we call them the Larceny Bourbon Locks and the Luna Azul Tequila Shots. This Thursday, join us for the free samples and all the fun that we have every single Thursday. Larceny Bourbon Locks and Luna Azul Tequila Shots.
Playoffs are here. This week, join us at Pearl Street Pizzeria in Geiston, Olio.
Hey, it's JMV, and maintain winter road readiness at your 14 Central Indiana CarX locations. Oil changes, tires, brakes, and more. 14 to serve you. That's CarX.com today.
It's Kevin and Querry.
Austin Meek covers the Michigan football program.
Hypothetically, Jim Irsay calls Jim Harbaugh in a week. I'll give you 3 years, $30 million right now. Any chance Jim Harbaugh says no?
I don't think so. I think it would be hard to turn that down, especially if part of the pitch is, hey, come to the NFL and you don't have to deal with this stuff that you have to deal with in college football right now. Opinion is if Jim Harbaugh had that opportunity, I think he'd probably take it.
Kevin and Querry.
Weekday mornings at 7
on 93.5 and 107.5. The Fan. The Ride with JMV.
Let me have a Diablo sandwich of Dr. Pepper. Make it fast. I'm in a damn hurry.
93.5 and 107.5. The Fan.
At Trackside's at 7 o'clock tonight. You know, as that promo mentioned a moment ago, too, Brent Halverson and I are betting analysts from Heaven Hill Distillery. Pearl Street. I had no idea until last week there was a Pearl Street other than the one downtown. This is near Geist. So that's on Thursday. Join us, and we will have... They challenged me not to say, hey, come up and we'll drink for free. I'm not allowed to say that. So you know exactly what that means when I say I'm not allowed to say it, but you can have samples. We give you a healthy sample. That's coming up on Thursday. Pearl Street, Oleo Geist. It is our postseason wild card edition of the Larceny Bourbon Locks and Luna Azul Tequila Shots. If you're on hold, do not go anywhere. From the Athletic on the Andy Moore Automotive Group hotline, it is Zach Keefer. I said this a little bit earlier. I'm not going to challenge whatsoever the sincerity of Chris Ballard from the presser. He was being honest about himself, and that is absolutely true, but it's not just this year. It's through the most part his six-year run here, which I would challenge why he's going to be given a seventh, but it's also going to be about accountability moving forward. Is he going to be able to adjust to what has failed him so far in his philosophies? He said that he's stubborn, and we know that to be true. Do you believe that he can change and make those adjustments moving forward?
Well, he needs to. And the words John today that he used were, I can be stubborn and dogmatic at times. And in the past, you know, a KB, Kevin Bowen, a colleague of yours at your station, has asked him, you know, questions about the receiver core. Why don't you have more receivers and the offensive line? There was none of that today in terms of shots at the media. This was, you know, what I didn't hear today, I didn't hear any excuses today. And honestly, I heard a lot of that yesterday when we talked to Jeff Saturday about the situation he inherited and the processes that were in place. And, oh, well, you know, the wins weren't going to really come because this was such a bad situation. Ballard today took everything on the chin, and as he should have. There's no other way to call it. He had to. And, no, that's the central question moving forward is, can he change his approach? Because his approach has gotten this team nowhere. No division titles, and just two playoff appearances in his 6 years. And really, at the end of his 6 year, they're at the worst point they've been in several decades.
You think he would be longer term, and in this case, into the 2023 season, still here, had there not been so much work to be done, the hiring of a coach, the drafting of a future quarterback, if he didn't have, or somebody, if that wasn't on the plate of the Colts right now, would he still be here? Would he still have that level of trust from Jim Irsay?
That's a really good point. I think it's completely fair, and I can't answer that for sure. Look, Jim thinks really highly of him. He does. He's told me that. And whatever everyone else thinks out there, really all that matters is what one guy thinks, the guy that's running this team. And his hands are dirty in this as well, and I wrote about that a lot last week. But the reality is this. I don't think he wanted to do a head coaching search and a general manager search. I don't think he wanted to pay Frank Reich. What's he paying him, $9 million a year to not coach this team?
Right.
And then pay Ballard whatever he'd have to pay Ballard, as well as the new GM and the new coach. And look, if you do that, then you're starting over completely from scratch at the three most important positions of a franchise, head coach, general manager, and quarterback. And the last time they did that was 2012. And they got the quarterback right. They didn't get the coach or the GM right. And it really, you know, the reasons they screwed that up is sort of the reasons why they're in the spot they're in right now.
Yeah, it is. I want to say different but the same, which doesn't make a lot of sense, but I get where you're going with that. Zach Keefer of the Athletic is on the Andy Moore Automotive Group hotline. It didn't seem like that it was anything but a foregone conclusion they were going to move forward with Chris Ballard. I do not, however, and again, I've stated this, it's easy for me to say it's not my money, but I don't want to hear anything about finances whatsoever playing a role as to why you continue. Either you have that deeply rooted belief that he is going to change things for the better, or you don't, and you move on. And I have been outspoken, Zach, as saying, listen, you're going to move on with a coach, you're going to move on with a quarterback, then everybody set everybody's clock on the same time right now, which clearly they're not going to do. But it can't be about finances here, can it?
Yeah, I'm with you on that. It's just setting yourself up for messy decisions down the line. And they did this in 2017, and it was a lame duck season for Chuck Pagano, and everybody knew it from the minute it started. And the messy situation that's going to come here is, what if Ballard hits on the quarterback? Does he stay? Is it all fixed? If he misses, is he gone in a year? What if the coach doesn't work with him. Like, you're just creating a headache that you don't necessarily need to create. But this is Jim Irsay's headache, and this is what he's done. And I'm with you, man. Like, he hasn't swung big on the head coach the last two times in terms of money. Money cannot be an issue with this next head coach. If you think Jim Harbaugh is the guy, and I asked Chris Ballard this point blank today, is he a candidate? He wouldn't answer me. They'd be crazy not to at least call Jim Harbaugh. And it's become pretty clear that Jim Harbaugh wants to be called. He wants to be interviewed. He interviewed with the Broncos on Monday. If you can't get him on the phone, what are you doing? So if he's going to want a lot of money, then pony up and pay this guy.
Indeed.
Yeah, you need to think. This is really important here. You need to think about this quarterback that you're going to draft, probably fourth overall. Maybe number one overall if you move up. This was a question today, and Chris Ballard said, I would absolutely move up if we think we want to get the guy at number one. You need to think about this head coach and this quarterback. That's the future of your franchise. And in my mind, you want to pair that quarterback with a quarterback-friendly coach who can develop him. Because just because you draft a quarterback doesn't mean you draft the right one. His development is going to be vital. You need to be thinking about that in these interviews as you plan the next phase of your franchise.
Again, I tell you, it's easy for me to say, but I say you go big there because, to me, he's the perfect get. And you don't mess around with this quarterback situation either. I mean, if Ryan Poles wants to be blown away by an offer, then start blowing. I shouldn't say it that way. But, yeah, blow him away then and make that offer and make sure that all of your chips are going to be in at some point here. You can go ahead and you fast forward. All chips are in to that. Because I think you want to have everything on the table for you to make the best chance of getting this quarterback long-term right.
Yeah, this is a good point we talked about in the media room today. What did the Chiefs give up to move up to get Mahomes? What did the Bills give up to move up to get Josh Allen? I don't remember. I don't think the casual fan remembers because it doesn't freaking matter. If you land the right – and I'm not saying they're going to draft Mahomes or Allen. It doesn't matter what you give up to go get that guy. If he's the guy – it's all worth it. It doesn't matter if it's two first-rounders or whatever. Like, if you give up capital to move up and get the guy and solve that position for the next 10 or 12 years, then everything is worth it, and no one's going to complain about the cost. So they need to be thinking about that as well. And look, the owner wants a quarterback. The owner is done with the veteran quarterback carousel, and I think a lot of fans out there are done as well.
You think right now, in terms of Jim Irsay, and I know we haven't heard from him, is Jeff Saturday the lead horse in the stable for the next head coach, if you were to ask Jim Irsay right now and he'd be honest?
That's hard to say. I think Saturday's star has dimmed a little bit in the last couple weeks.
Even now, with
this
Jim?
Is me talking.
Even with Jim?
This is, even. I mean, like, look, I know that Irsay's been a little impetuous this season, but he has to see the problem. Right? I mean, he has to see how poorly this team played down the stretch. And I'll tell you this. This is me talking. This is not Chris Ballard talking, but my takeaway from the press conference today was there's no way in a couple of weeks Chris Ballard recommends to Jim Irsay that Jeff Saturday should be the next coach. That's just me jumping to a conclusion, but I got nothing told me today that that's going to be Chris Ballard's decision. Now, Jim's going to make the final call. Irsay is going to make the final call. So anything is possible. We've learned that over the last couple of months. But nothing Chris Ballard said today and nothing he's said over the last couple of months has hinted at me that he wants to that he thinks Jeff Saturday should be the long-term answer.
Yeah.
But he's not making the call.
No. And you're right. Yeah, there's no way. There's no way. And I think you could tell that today. And
Chris has screwed up plenty, but he's not an idiot.
I mean, Chris is not going to go out and, you know, crap on Jeff Saturday, Ring of Honor, Golden Era type of guy like that either, even if he believes he deserves to be crapped on by the way things went in the remainder of that season, those eight games in which he was front and center as the coach. I just, somebody had asked me this earlier, Zach. They said, you know, I don't think by virtue of what I heard from Ballard today that Saturday has a chance. And my answer was, as long as Jim Irsay is running things, and that's going to be for a long time, he's going to have a chance. Would you agree with that?
Yeah. Yeah, I would. I would. And the strange part is, you ask coaches and you ask players and you ask Chris Ballard today, like, what did Jeff do in his eight games? Like, what did he do to deserve this chance to run this team full time? And not one time have I heard he did a good job coaching this team. And this is not to just, you know, harp on Jeff. Like, he's a great dude. He's a great Colt. He's a Ring of Honor guy. He's been great with us. But the reality is this team got worse in every conceivable way. And when players tell you, you know, he's a good leader, you know, he's a good motivator, he held us accountable, that's great. That doesn't win in this league. That doesn't win in this league. Coaching matters in this league. Look at what the Giants did this year. Going from a four-win team to a playoff team without a lot of pop on offense, right? Like, coaching matters. And the Colts didn't have it over the last eight games, and it really hurt them. And that is front and center. And everybody out there that's listening that watched this team get worse by the week, that's all the evidence you need. But like you said, it doesn't matter because one guy's making the decision at the end of the day, and he likes Jeff Saturday, and he seems to be convinced that Jeff Saturday can be a long-term solution.
Zach Keefer of the Athletics on the Andy Moore Automotive Group Hotline. So, what length of time? What's the timetable you think for this, as it stands?
Yeah, Chris Ballard today said this could go into mid-February. He's going to be prudent. He's going to be patient. He's going to take his time. I'd expect 2 weeks of interviews at the very least. But as someone told me a couple of weeks ago, you know, these things can change really fast. So if they go into a second interview with a guy and they really like him, there could be an offer soon. So things could change quickly, but I think they're going to take their time. The one thing I'm a little confused at right now is they've requested a lot of OCs, a lot of DCs right now.
Yeah.
Where's Harbaugh? Where's Harbaugh's name in this? And if it's not in this, why is it not in this? But we asked that question today.
So some dude called me today. I'm sorry to interrupt here, but some dude called me today, just actually last hour, and said he was watching Dan Patrick, and Tom Pelissero said, and who knows if this is true or not, I'm not getting on the guy for saying this, but maybe he misunderstood, that Tom Pelissero of the NFL Network suggested that the reason why the Colts have not reached out or Jim Harbaugh has not been connected to the Colts yet is because Jim likes Jeff Saturday and doesn't want to do it that way. That doesn't sound right, but it was just odd to me when he said that. I didn't happen to see the Dan Patrick show to know. So,
yeah, and I'm not dismissing Tom's report. He's dead on with everything, and he talks to the right people. But that sounds strange to me.
Strange. Yeah, I mean, listen, this sounds as strange as the Colts not reaching out at all. Or, you know, Jim Harbaugh and Jim Harbaugh's folks not showing interest if the Colts did reach out. So this doesn't make a lot of sense why there's been no connection. There's got to be something else going on here, I guess, is what we're talking about, right?
Yeah, and the other element is a lot of people have mentioned, like, how attractive is this job? We know what's happened over the last couple of months. Now, Ballard is running the search. Now, Ballard is making the interviews, and he's going to run this. But I don't think Jim Harbaugh is a guy that would be scared from this situation, messy as it might look, right? And they do have an attractive piece in the fact that they have the fourth overall pick and you can draft a quarterback and groom him. And let's say that's C.J. Stroud. Like, Harbaugh knows that guy. Like, Harbaugh, you know, game planned against C.J. Stroud. And he knows the league as well. I mean, he took Colin Kaepernick to a Super Bowl. So he knows the position. I wouldn't think he'd be scared away from a team that doesn't have a quarterback in place right now. But again, I'm speculating and I'm a little confused like the rest of us.
Hey, I want you to rank this before we go. Rank the two coaches and the general manager, 1 through 3, which of the three are the absolute best at talking themselves back into a job or maintaining their gig? Pagano, Gregson, or Ballard? How would you rank them?
Yeah, Ballard's the best in front of a microphone. And I don't mean that in a dismissive way. He gets up there and tells it like it is for the most part. Now, they all are politicians to some degree. I'm not going to touch the other two, man. I don't want to go back to 2016.
Well, that was more in private. That was done privately, though. That was more privately, I think, where, you know, everybody shared tears and what was going to be did not come to pass on that particular day. But, yeah, I would agree. Right. As far as politicianing is concerned, the guy that did that presser earlier today is at the very top of the list.
Yeah, man, if we're dealing with private therapy sessions between the head coach and GM like we were 6 years ago, man, I need to find another job because I can't do that again.
Yeah, that's tough. It is. All right, I know you got everything on The Athletic written about today and then longer term. I appreciate you jumping on here, man.
All right, thanks, John.
Zach Key for The Athletic on the Andy Moore Automotive Group Hotline. Quick break, your calls, and in fact, we are wide open. We decided not to do anything at the 5 o'clock hour, so we would actually have plenty of time for you to state your opinion. So 239-1070. Other side, into the 5 o'clock hour, the Tuesday edition of this show. 93.5 and 107.5 The Fan.
Home shows provide homeowners the deepest discounts of the year on remodeling projects. And right now, Window Nation is bringing home show savings right into your home. Schedule a free, no obligation, in-home demonstration today and lock in this incredible offer. Get two free windows with every two you buy with no limit. Plus, pay no interest for 60 months. Imagine the savings in cost and lower energy bills, but you don't just have to imagine how beautiful new Window Nation windows will look on your home. You can see it. Use their free virtual visualizer at windownation.com/homeshow. Upload a picture of your house and try out hundreds of options online. Get design tips from the experts and learn how Window Nation's trained installation specialists have helped over 150,000 homes with over 96% satisfaction. But remember, these once-a-year home show savings are for a very limited time. Call Window Nation today at 866-90-NATION or go to windownation.com/homeshow. Get two windows free with every two you buy. Pay no interest for 60 months. That's five full years. 866-90-NATION or go to windownation.com/homeshow.
I love my friends at Farm Credit Union, and so will you. Always coming up with these incredibly unique, very original, and as I would say from GC, the smart's real good ways for you to finance, to budget your monthly finances, to live a better financial existence with my friends at Farm Credit Union. In fact, they help businesses reach their goals with personalized services to help with borrowing, everyday financial needs, so much more, including videos, too, that you can watch to help with you inside your home on your monthly budgeting situation. Nobody better than Forum Credit Union. Stop by a branch location, find out more. Right now, you can find out at your fingertips. That's forumcu.com.
Hey, this is Lisa Stofan. Heard the Mark Patrick weight loss hypnosis hype? Well, I attended because my father stopped smoking with hypnosis. Hypnosis eliminated my desire for soda and fast food, made me want to exercise, and I lost 60 pounds in 6 months. My energy level exploded. I went to another session to deal with some other problem foods, and I lost another 10 pounds. In fact, I brought my husband, and he lost weight, and his cholesterol and blood pressure improved. My friend lost 20 pounds her first 2 months.
What are you waiting for? Join Mark Patrick Seminars and lose the weight or stop smoking guaranteed for only $49.99. Hypnosis designed to destroy unwanted cravings, late-night eating binges, boredom eating, stress eating. Seminars Thursday, January 19th at the Holiday Inn Express and Suites in Noblesville. Weight loss seminar 5:30, stop smoking seminar 8 p.m. And Saturday, January 21st at the Holiday Inn Indianapolis Airport. Weight loss seminar 11 a.m., stop smoking seminar 2 p.m. Register at markpatrickseminars.com.
Bonus days are back for pros at Lowe's. You earn points and save when you buy the top pro brands you trust, like DeWalt. Right now, you can save $100 on the powerful DeWalt 8.25-inch carbide tipped portable table saw. Was $399, now just $299. Join today and shop bonus days, only at Lowe's. Bonus points calculated before taxes and fees after applicable discounts, if any, valid through 120. Subject to change while supplies last. Visit Lowe's.com/MVPs bonus points for details.
Knockouts Haircuts for Men is the new place to trust with your hair care and grooming.
Knockouts is a high-end, full-service salon for men.
They pamper you while you relax and enjoy a precision cut. Top-notch stylists and barbers.
Every style. Cuts, fades, all hair types. Beard care, color, and waxing available.
At Knockouts, get a complimentary beverage with any service. Knockouts Haircuts for Men.
Two Indy locations.
US 36 and Avon next to Tropical Smoothie Cafe. Clearwater. And Clearwater Keystone next to Drake's.
Walk-ins welcome.
Or appointments at 288-0007 or knockouts.com.
Everyone knows that in Indiana, game time...
Here's a deep three. Halliburton!
...means family time.
He's got family in Kokomo. That might have been from Howard County.
The Atlanta Hawks come to town this Friday for Lucas Oil Family Night. Family Night tickets start at just $20 and includes a Pacers hat, hot dog, chips, and small Pepsi product. Get your Family Night tickets at Pacers.com/family. That's Pacers.com/family. Pacers, Hawks, Friday at 7.
Yo, Pablo Torre here, host of the ESPN Daily Podcast. When you want to go beyond your feed, when you want to get inside the score, when you want to get behind the highlight, there's ESPN Daily. Go deeper into the stories of the moment. Get the exclusive access and insider perspective that only ESPN can give you. ESPN Daily, hosted by me, Pablo Torre. Listen and subscribe wherever you get your podcasts.
The Pacers head to the Big Apple to face the New York Knicks tomorrow night at 7 on 93.5 and 107.5 The Fan.
The Ride with JMV.
Ahoy, Ploy.
93.5 and 107.5 The Fan.
Yeah, we'll work through that. I had a good talk with Matt yesterday. We'll work through that. Right now, it's about the head coach. You know, our staff's evaluating our roster. We'll work through that. But right now, the priority of the organization is to get the right head football coach.
Ballard from earlier today on the press conference happened at about 10:30. We're playing bits and pieces of that and then conversing about it with you, 239-1070. The email address, jmv at 107.5thefan.com, on Twitter at jmv1070. Inside the lounge via YouTube Live, where everybody in there is checking out my brand new, thank you very much, Harley D and Nicole, big red T-shirt right now. Thanks for the memories and the kidney stones, Big Red. Thank you. Shout out to Big Red for the kidney stones. That felt really good. Ever pop out a kidney stone? Want to talk about that? Or has this four-win season kind of felt like passing a kidney stone? Marcellus at 239-1070. Welcome to the show, Marcellus.
What's up, my friend? How you doing?
You going to be here on Saturday night, too? Your call was, once again, fantastic.
Hey, man. Thank you.
What did we go? We went with Computer Blue by Prince and the Revolution, and we went with Prince and Sheena Easton. You got the look, right?
Yeah, that's right, man. Beautiful. That's right. Hey, man, thanks for doing what you do, man.
Yeah, you know that. I love doing it. Thank you for being along.
I know you do, man. Hey, this is hilarious, man. I was just I listened to the press conference today, man. And I think I had this image of the Jedi mind trick from Star Wars. Ballard comes in, you know, and you can almost hear a hush go across the press room, man. Like people say, "Oh, bless his heart."
I am the GM you're looking for.
Right. He's like, bless his heart. He failed. He said he failed. Oh, yeah, look, man, enough already. Okay. And then he says he has the nerve to say, and nobody challenged him on it. And it's like, he said, you can't fail or you get canceled. Oh, wait a minute, Chris. You can fail, man. Just not 6 years in a row. Okay. That's all. That's all we asking, man. And it's 1 year, 2 years, JMV, three.
I know.
You know, but not 6 years in a row. Yeah, you can fail. You have just done that.
I'd like to see, Marcellus, we got to look up to see who has gone six and now 7+ years with results like this at the general managing position in the NFL. That seems unheard of.
Hey, man, maybe I could say Marvin Lewis breaks a record as coaching.
I mean, when Mike Brown was running the Bengals, I guess, right?
I mean, I didn't know what it would take for Marvin Lewis to lose his job down there, man. It was so many years just getting bounced. But I'm not looking for anybody to lose their job. I'm just saying, man.
I know what you mean, yeah.
Yeah, this is so many things that you and I have talked about over this tenure, man, the decisions, the ignoring things, and not only just, you know, the people he's brought in, but we can criticize who he's let go out the door. People he decided couldn't play anymore, now still wreaking havoc in the NFL, who obviously could still play. And it's like, okay, you know, so
I'm going to ask you this before I let you go here, too. I've asked others this, and they don't know, and that's logical because we're not there yet. But are we going to see a change in philosophy? Because, you know, he mentioned today, I failed, and he was just talking about this year. His philosophy has failed. That's overall. That's a 6-year philosophy that's failed, not just this year. Does he have a change in philosophy, a change in heart about what he believes a team and how a team should be built this year, or is that lip service today?
Well, let me say this. I'm going to answer it this way. When they asked him if about a number one receiver, he said he didn't know what that was. Okay, there you go. Okay, yeah.
He hadn't seen it. Yeah, I guess, right?
Hey, I know we all know what a number one receiver looks like, JMV.
I know.
We know Marvin Harrison. We know my man Hill down in Miami. We know those guys that take the top off, that you have the ambient players that Venturi always talks about. We know what they look like, and he does too. But he played coy, so no, I don't think he's changing anything.
Marcellus, I appreciate your call. I'll talk to you on Saturday night.
All right, my man.
All right, quick break, and we'll come back. I got the 5 o'clock hour in full for your conversations. And believe me, if you are a believer moving forward and you disagree, and I challenge Chris Ballard to change my mind, to prove me wrong on this, and I hope that he does. But was your mind changed today by the presser? Do you stay the same? Do you believe in Ballard moving forward, or are you like me and thinking if you're going to do with a quarterback and the head coach, the general manager, just reset all three of those major pieces within your football organization? Quick break. 5 o'clock hour, nothing but you and me. Next.
It has no beginning.
The start of something special right here, man. Let's go.
And no end.
Look, you got to get your team ready to play.
It is a constant.
Yeah! Get a rhythm going.
Through every season.
Come back again.
It is always Colts season. Firing, hiring, free agency, the combine, the schedule, the draft, OTAs, minicamp, training camp, kickoff, the offseason.
Questions
is a season
to be answered for this Colts team.
The best Colts coverage is on 93.5 and 107.5 The Fan.
Are you ready? Bonus days are back for pros at Lowe's. You earn points and save when you buy the top pro brands you trust, like DeWalt. Right now, you can save $100 on the powerful DeWalt 8.25-inch carbide tipped portable table saw. Was $399, now just $299. Join today and shop bonus days, only at Lowe's. Bonus points calculated before taxes and fees after applicable discounts, if any, valid through 120, subject to change while supplies last. Visit Lowe's.com/MVPs bonus points for details.
Helzberg Diamonds presents The Guy Who Was the MVP. Craig was proposing to his girlfriend and needed the perfect ring, so he asked her friends for some advice.
Get yourself to Helzberg.
Yep, Craig went to Helzberg Diamonds. He learned that Helzberg's been in business for over 100 years. That means quality. And with their price match guarantee, he'd get a great deal and find the perfect ring.
Wow! It's perfect. Oh, yeah.
MVP. Most valuable proposer. Be like Craig. Find the ring of her dreams at a Helzberg Diamonds near you or at Helzberg.com.
When you can't stop, there's Vicks VapoRub. Vicks VapoRub sends powerful medicated Vicks vapors right to the source of your... so you can experience cough relief and breathe easier. Generations of families have trusted Vicks VapoRub to help relieve the worst cold symptoms. So next time you have a cough, reach for the Vicks VapoRub. Vicks VapoRub. Cough relieving is believing.
Hey, it's John here for your 14 Central Indiana. Joe Childers run CarX locations. You got to maintain that winter road readiness and get in there from tires to brakes to brake pads, coolant exchanges, of course, oil changes. You know how much with my truck with 304,000 miles plus on it right now that I feel it is important to maintain. And what do? I slide up to the Brownsburg location most of the time. The 14 Central Indiana CarX locations run by Joe Childers. I promise there's one near you. Maintain that winter road readiness today. And to find that location nearest you, it's CarX.com.
And now a small business setback is assessed by a beloved family pediatrician.
Oh, hey, Tiger. Big Scary Tree Ranch give your work truck a boo-boo? Yeah. Wow. See this thing on my phone here? It's the Progressive Mobile app. Just push that little button there and report your claim. Attaboy.
When owning a small business gets painful, Progressive Commercial is here to make it all better. Get a quote in as little as 6 minutes at ProgressiveCommercial.com.
What's this? Candy drawer? Who wants a lollipop?
Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and affiliates. Coverage subject to policy terms and conditions. Photo claims not available in all states or situations.
Need new tires? Skip the long appointments and bad coffee. With Go Mobile Tires Indy, order tires online and have them installed at your home or office. GoMobileIndy.com. We come to you.
Dan Dockage for Affinity Whole Health, the leader in testosterone therapy. They've got me on a testosterone program. Gotta tell you, I feel amazing. Get started at FeelGreatIndy.com. That's FeelGreatIndy.com.
93.5 and 107.5. The Fan.
WIBC HD2 W298BB WIBC HD3 W228CX Indianapolis.
The Pacers head to the Big Apple to face the New York Knicks tomorrow night at 7. on 93.5 and 107.5 The Fan.
The Ride with JMV. 93.5 and 107.5 The Fan.
No, like we don't have a transfer portal. We don't have that, and I don't want it. I've never backed out of anything in my life. And I won't back out of this, and we'll get it right. People are scared to struggle. I'm not gonna sit here and say I like it, but I'm not afraid of it. I'm not afraid of the struggle. I'm not afraid of the hardness of what we do. Matter of fact, I kind of get off on it. And to answer your question, no. No other place I want to be but Indy.
All right. Wait a minute. Yeah. Well, the struggle is not common to what I want to get off on. But I guess that's a way to try to tell everybody that you've got a lot of strength and you can get past the past 6 years that have been, for the most part, really crappy and still maintain your gig as the general manager, right? I tell you what I'd like to get off on, and it's not a struggle. It'd be like what we're watching with the Pacers right now, and I kind of jokingly call, you know, things sports arousals. That's it. Oh, but it's ahead of schedule. Oh, but it's not real. Well, it looks real right now. We'll figure out whether or not it's fool's gold later on. But as I mentioned, with the struggle, at least from my gig, comes the negativity. And I sit here every day, and all I do is piss and moan about this football team, and I'm tired of it. So judging on those results, that's where I'm a non-believer. Skivvy says, was that Ballard's sports arousal? I thought what he said at the outset about him failing would suffice. And that diffused everything. And I mentioned this. That is a page out of the JMV Sucks playbook. Hey, JMV sucks. JMV, you suck. Well, really? They make t-shirts about it. So, yeah, I know. I know that. And that's not only is it fun to do, but it can be even for those knobs out there that actually believe that, it can be diffusing. So what do? You come out and do the only thing you can. You absolutely own everything. But he was talking about just 1 year. And I'm talking about the body of work, which I think is drastically different and even more damning in this case. I got a question, though. How many of you out there believe that maybe he continues to move forward as the general manager because of these major decisions that need to be made, and they don't want to make all three major? And I know that Jim Irsay has had his fingerprints on everything, especially recently. But do you think that by any stretch he wants to do all of this? And all of this basically by himself, or all this calling up old friends to help with judgment here? Does Ballard continue moving forward because there is a head coaching vacancy and there is a deeply rooted, accurate thought that they're going to have to draft a top-ranked quarterback? Nick Rice writes this. Ballard is afraid to struggle because he won't draft a wide receiver or a quarterback. JMV, Chris Ballard, I kind of get off on the struggle. And I don't mind the quote at all, but that's just my point is here, and then the reason why he's moving forward there. I'm just kind of dropping in some stuff that maybe you haven't thought about yet. Let's go Kevin at 239-1070. All of you and all of me in this 5 o'clock hour regarding Chris Ballard, really anything you want to drop in, but certainly that presser earlier today. Kevin, welcome to the show.
Hey, JMB, I love the show. I just want to say that I think the blame starts at the very top with Jim Irsay. you know, he is the one that made the decision to extend the contracts of Reich and Ballard prematurely without any results. And I just feel like moving forward, keeping Ballard is the wrong decision.
You think one of the chief reasons is because they have these big decisions to be made, and you got to have somebody for the first two, so you keep the general manager. Did that help save Chris from this 4-win season, you think, moving forward at all, or was it still owing him all that money up through the year 2026? What do you think more saved him here?
I think those are both fair points. I don't think money is the issue, but maybe just the apprehension of maybe not having anyone to help make decisions. I think that's a fair point.
Kevin, you got anything else on your mind on this Tuesday?
I just want to say I love Jake Query. I met him at Red River Gorge when we were hiking several years back, and he was completely he acted like he was nobody. I knew who he was. It was complete random meeting, and he was a great guy. Love Jake Query.
Yeah, he's a great dude. JMV. No, thank you, Kevin. I appreciate that. Yeah, Jake's a good dude. We've been friends for 22 years. And we were friends when he and Derek did the other show. And that's absolutely unheard of, because normally in the same market you have shows that go opposite of one another. It's a battle of jackassery. But we never did that. Always been a friend. And Derek, too, for that matter. All right, 239-1070. Eric is up next. Eric, welcome to the show.
Thank you for your time, my friend. The one thing I wanted to ask you about, I totally agree with Jim Harbaugh taking over, but do you think he would want to come in here with this joke of a general manager unless he could go in there and take the GM job himself and do both?
Okay, you have that, by the way. I was talking to James here just for a second. Eric, do I think that Harbaugh would want to do both general managing and coaching? Is that what you said?
Yeah. Yeah.
No, I don't think that'd be the criteria. Listen, I don't know what he would want, and maybe he wouldn't want to work with Ballard. Maybe he just doesn't want to come here. Maybe that's the case. Eric, I just happen to think for what this position is right now and what this organization looks like right now, if you're asking me who would be a perfect fit, the most perfect fit at coach, he would be it. Moving forward.
I totally agree because here's one reason why I'd be interested in him being the general manager. This guy knows the college market, and I'm not convinced that this clown of a GM does.
I would be more concerned about this, that Jim Harbaugh knows what he's getting into, has handled it before, and is out there enough to where he's not going to take anything. He's going to do what he wants to do, and he's going to move forward with that, and he, I believe, would have success with it sooner rather than later. And with all of what you're trying to do with a new head coach, with what's going to be a longer-term new quarterback that you want to try to develop, and with a team that a lot of folks would say within that organization has gone completely soft by virtue of Frank Reich and where it is right now, I think he would be perfect. I'm not suggesting he's going to be. I don't know if either side has any interest whatsoever. But to me, if there's one name out there that is above everybody else, Eric, that's it.
I totally agree. Let me ask you two quick things.
Yeah.
Who do you want to see drafted as a quarterback?
C.J. Stroud. C.J. Okay. Stroud. I would draft C.J. Stroud. If I had the number one overall pick right now, I would draft C.J. Stroud. And I'm sitting here right now, who knows, maybe that changes with the combine and all this crap. I doubt it, because I love what he certainly gave in that semifinal against Georgia. The movement out of the pocket, the escapability, the arm strength, the accuracy against the best team in the nation, that's what holds me to C.J. Stroud over anything else. That's who I would take.
I totally agree with you. Now, this Ballard situation, in your mind, what was he thinking? In order for us to go forward, why would you keep Ballard? And who would you put in?
But, well, and at the top of that list, and Eric, thank you for the call, it's because Jim Irsay does trust him. Jim Irsay has a level of trust in him that a lot of us do not. And that's what matters. Now, we could also, if you want to, we could debate whether or not it's financial. You're paying a coach not to coach. You're going to pay another coach to coach. You're paying a general manager. Do you want to pay the general manager through 2026 and then pay another general manager to come in? Do you want to change up all in one hiring cycle, the general manager, the coach, and add a long-term high first-round draft pick at quarterback? Do you want to have to do all that at once? I would suggest you might as well just start everything from the lowest level and build it up. I mean, if you're going to change out, you obviously start with a quarterback. You get a head coach, the general manager too, especially the general manager and the coach at one level. But that is not, alas, how they're going to do it. I believe this is Sean Rogers inside the lounge via YouTube Live. Are you that Sean Rogers here?
Yes, sir, Jack.
I told you, I'd put you on here if you called. You're going to represent the lounge via YouTube Live right now, so hey, don't screw this up, or they're going to come at you in there, okay?
Right on. I appreciate you, but your take on Miles Turner,
mm-hmm.
I mean, it's coming to an end. I mean, look, the guy hasn't played the second half of a season, the last two seasons, and he wants a boatload of money. The Pacers just offered him multiple, from what I've heard.
Oh, you don't know what they offered him? You have no idea.
Right. But from any news sources, he's turned down contract offers, right? That's what I've heard anyway. That he's turned down any Pacers extension offers. Let the dude go. He has not.
Are you shocked that he didn't jump on the first one? How about $1.50, Miles? Okay, I'll do it. Are you shocked he didn't jump on the first one? Are you shocked that there is a utilization of the media and reports to negotiate? This sounds pretty familiar.
No, I'm not shocked about anything. I don't know the details as far as.
Why don't you? Why have you not, Sean? Why have you not embraced Miles?
Turner has done nothing the second half of any season. He's proven nothing in the playoffs because he hasn't even taken a team to that point. He wants all this money for a guy that's played half the season the last 2 years. Really? That's what we should do? We got Mathurin. We got a lot of young players coming up. Halliburton, we don't need to spend money on Turner. Turner hasn't even proved he can play an entire season, and he's not a leader. The dude has turned to the media a few times to whine about his situation, and I'm glad just now this season that he's decided to be a man about it and say, hey, I like playing for this team. Great, that ups your trade value. But, hey, do me a favor, Miles Turner. Play.
You don't like the way he's playing right now? You don't like the way he's playing with his team?
He is playing great right now, JMV. I love how Miles is playing right now. I absolutely love how he's playing right now. And I wish he could continue playing this way the entire season for the rest of his career. But we have not seen that, have we? We have not seen Miles Turner do that.
You have not seen this level of consistency, which you're seeing right now. Why can't you just embrace that right now? Why don't you feel good about it? A team ahead of schedule, and he's an integral part of that, Sean, right now. Why don't you embrace it?
I absolutely love the Pacers, and I love how Miles Turner is playing right now. That's not my argument, JMV.
You don't trust him, is what you're saying. You don't trust him?
You're talking about a boatload of money and the future of this franchise and where this money needs to go. And we got players, Isaiah Jackson and some other players underneath that deserve playing time.
Yeah, they're not ready to scratch their ass yet. You know that. Isaiah Jackson goes out there and gets 9 fouls before he even checks into the game. He's not ready for that right now. They don't have guys that are ready for that.
So invest a boatload of money into Miles Turner that has not proven that he can stay healthy. That's what you want us to do.
No, he's 26 years old, and he has proven that he fits perfectly with the group that you brought in to mold. That's what he's proven.
He's proven he's great the first half of the season before teams actually start trying and getting ready for playoffs. Right now, Lakers are warming up. Right now, teams are warming up for the playoffs. Miles Turner hadn't even sticked his toes into anything to do with tournament.
I don't think no matter what Miles would do, you would like Miles. I think that you're in that category of the nub nuttishness that I've referenced before. No matter what he does, you're not going to like it. You're just not going to like it.
If you could guarantee me that Miles Turner was going to stay healthy.
I can't guarantee you anybody's going to stay healthy, brother. How am I going to do that?
That's right.
So but I do know this. I do know this, that he is absolutely different. He is transformed with this group, and especially Tyrese Halliburton. And, Sean, man, if you can't see that, you are never going to see it. If you can't see what he adds to this team, the evolution of this team, the watchability, the winning nature on the defensive end and on the offensive end, if you can't see this right now, Sean, you're never going to get it. You're never going to see it because you don't want to, because you want to make fun of him. You want to call him soft. You want to say he did yoga. He likes Legos. He likes Star Wars. All this stupid blank that does not matter. What matters is what he does on the floor. What matters is what he's been doing on the floor with a new group. With what he does on the floor with this core group that's going to be around here for a long time. Build it. Don't jack with it. Embrace it. Don't criticize it. Go with it. I've said this before. Go with the buzz. Nothing wrong with going with the buzz. Don't qualify your opinion about him right now for what he's done in the past. Let's live in the moment. Embrace the moment when something good is happening. And don't sit around and wait for the crap to occur. My God, that's what everybody around here is like, and it drives me nuts. Inside the Lounge via YouTube Live is where you can see some of those musings of Sean. I'm selling the Lounge via YouTube Live right now with Sean's call. Derek's up next at 239-1070. Derek, welcome to the show.
Hey, thank you, brother. First of all, I've got three quick things, and then I'll let you,
you got
talk
it.
Here. Number one, you mentioned Query and your long-term relationship.
Yes.
I've listened to your show a long time. You were incredibly classy the day that 1260 changed their game plan and cut Ian Derek loose. You were incredibly classy throughout the show that day, expressing your opinion on how, even though they were on a different station, you wished them all the best. And I thought that was just a very classy thing for you.
Well, they are not only my friends, always have been and always will be, but I know this to be true about any market of radio, and especially this one, and especially with radio in general. You want to have the most options out there. I mean, you do. You need the most options because you have way too many other options that are non-radio related where people are turning their attention to. I want to keep everybody's attention in this market. And that was always a thought. And that was just the business aspect. But the personal aspect is that I've always liked Jake and Derek a great deal, and that was a bad day for Indianapolis and radio.
Absolutely. Second thing, I called about 6 weeks ago. Right after the Steelers and Colts had played, I've lived in Indiana my whole life, southern Indiana for the first part of my life, and made some comparisons between the Steelers and the Colts. In those six weeks since, Steelers 5-1, Colts, we all know. And part of this, I think you can sort of make a comparison and draw those Pacers in. You are spot on that Irsay is the issue, and I hope you also make this frequently touch on a theme about how Indiana fans of sports have suffered for a long time, and we're enjoying a little bit of a renaissance
right, with
Purdue and the Pacers. And I think you're spot on. And the common denominator between the Steelers and the Pacers is you don't have an owner that's really meddling in the operations. Pritchard ought to be commended big time. He's made a lot of gutsy calls, made a lot of chicken salad out of a poor situation. And look at who we've got and who they've assembled. And I think your criticisms of Ballard, if you compared Ballard and what he's done with the playbook he's been given and the purse strings he's been given versus Pritchard and the Pacers, there's no comparison whatsoever.
Can I tell you this too, Derek, and I'll let you finish with what the Pacers are doing right now, and this has consistently been the means in which we describe this market as nobody in the NBA wants to come and play here. And I know that at the top of the list is all about money. But I think right now, that this particular group, led by Tyrese Haliburton, is going to become more embraceable for the rest of the NBA to say, you know what, I really like what they're doing there. They're enjoying it. That's a great brand of basketball to be played. I'm not suggesting that this is going to become a go-to market by any stretch. It is not, but it right now is becoming more of a bright light of, wow, that would be fun to play with that group than it has been in forever around here.
Totally agree. The if you can't say that you're not having fun watching the Pacers, then you're clearly not watching the Pacers. They are incredibly athletic. Their teamwork is unselfish. And I know you just had your guy from the lounge in there talking about Miles.
Yeah.
Let me just say something. Miles was drafted to play like he's playing right now, but they didn't have the personnel
correct
at the time he was drafted. And now you're seeing how Turner can play. And if you don't think he's a difference maker on both ends of the floor, then you're really just not understanding the NBA game.
Well, today. And then there are people like Sean, as you mentioned, from the lounge, that will never get it. Because they don't right. want to get it. Because there are other reasons why. He's got bib overalls on, you know. He's dressing oddly. You know, look at him. He loves Legos and all this other stuff that doesn't matter. What matters is when he goes out there, what matters is right now when he goes out there and how great of a fit he is with this group. And why in the world you would say, yeah, go ahead, it'd be great to lose that because I don't trust his health. You can't trust anybody's health. You never know that. But what you can do is embrace the goodness of what's going on right now and hope that that continues, because clearly both Chad Buchanan and Kevin Pritchett with this group, they found a little bit of something, and that's nice.
Yeah. Can I offer one question?
Yes.
And then I'll let you go.
Yeah.
In terms of, like, I just want two Colts on the line that people have really maligned this year, and fairly, and very fairly, are Nelson and Kelly. And I just wonder, in both cases, if there's not something under the surface that at least the question could be asked of those guys.
Well, like, with Kelly, there's no doubt. Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, mentally, with what he experienced a year ago as a human being and a personal family tragedy, I think it would be real hard to say that is not some sort of cloud there. And in Nelson's case, I just wonder about his recovery from his injury, and that stuff's never really talked about. And I understand there are privacy matters to some of those things, but it really their performance on the field clearly was not at the level that it was the last year, the last two, the last three. And I just wonder what kind of toll that is, and with your two big guys that you're paying big money to, because they have performed, it just makes you wonder if there are some things that the, you know, under the radar that...
Yeah, the next scapegoat that we're going to hear, about is going to be Chris Strasser, the O-line coach. I mean, whether or not, you know, he wasn't good, was good, whatever, and thanks for the call, Derek, the next scapegoat you're going to get is Strasser. Because they'll say, well, you know, the reason they got to be coached up better, that's going to be the next scapegoat. When these guys, just for the most part, actually not even for the most part, consistently didn't have the level in which was expected. That's also on Chris Ballard. Sorry, but he's also going to have to own the fact that that group that he put together, that group that he extended, that group that he trusts as being one of the best in the NFL, did not play that way. All right, other side, we'll get back to your calls as well. Also, what Rick Venturi had to say, do you have that over there? The Rick Venturi comments regarding Jeff Saturday last night on Colts Roundtable Live. Tom Pelissero was on Dan Patrick. Do you have that too? We'll play that coming back. Somebody had asked me a little bit earlier about Jim Harbaugh because he would be at the top of my coaching list. And what Tom Pelissero told Dan Patrick this morning on Dan Patrick's show about maybe why we haven't heard any connection or relation between the Colts and Jim Harbaugh. That and your calls next.
Hopefully, you'll never have a house or business fire. But if you do, Hopefully, you'll never forget this name, Michelas. They can be there before that lump in your throat goes away. In fact, they're the reason it goes away. Over 35 years of helping people recover from faulty wiring, lightning strikes, or that unattended pot of pasta on the stove. Michelas crews often roll in before the fire hoses are rolled up. Their proven process of water extraction, smoke removal, and content storage will calm your nerves. Then their talented craftsmen will rebuild your home and restore your spirits. That starts by being your advocate with the insurance company. You'll find Michelas doesn't just feel for you, they work for you. Water, storms, fire, and foundations. Life happens. Michelas happens to help you through it. Call 844-FIX-INDY. Make it Michelas.
Get in zone, AutoZone.
Welcome to AutoZone. What are you working on today? Thinking about gas mileage. You know, changing your oil with a full synthetic oil like Valvoline Advanced can help your engine get more miles. Right now, you can get 5 quarts with an STP Extended Life Oil Filter for only $38.99. Go farther with better fuel efficiency. Get the parts you need when you need them at AutoZone or AutoZone.com.
Get in the zone, AutoZone.
Restrictions apply.
Knockouts Haircuts for Men is the new place to trust with your hair care and grooming.
Knockouts is a high-end, full-service salon for men. They pamper you while you relax and enjoy a precision cut. Top-notch stylists and barbers.
Every style.
Cuts, fades, all hair types. Beard care, color, and waxing available.
At Knockouts, get a complimentary beverage with any service.
Knockouts Haircuts for Men.
2 Indy locations.
US 36 and Avon next to Tropical Smoothie Cafe. And Clearwater Keystone next to Drake's.
Walk-ins welcome.
Or appointments at 288-0007 or knockouts.com.
D&G Fitness Equipment's New Year, New You sale is happening now. Build strength with an all-in-one gym and enjoy your workout from the comfort of home with D&G Fitness Equipment. Special financing is available. LiveFit.com for details.
It's Kevin and Querry.
The Colts lose another heartbreaker to wrap up the season.
The Colts were trying to win that game, and yet the Colts are so abysmally inept and pathetic that the team that was trying to hold on to the number one pick in the draft won. It was such an egregious yet predictable victory over the hapless Colts that their coach still got fired.
Kevin and Querry.
Weekday mornings at 7.
On 93.5 and 107.5. The Fan. The Ride with JMV.
Fat, drunk, and stupid is no way to go through life, son.
93.5 and 107.5. The Fan.
What about the Colts?
Don't count out Jeff Saturday. That is the one thing. For all the uncertainty about what direction this goes, and the full plan with the Colts is to cast a wide net. They're going to talk to a lot of people. They put out, I believe, 4 interview requests yesterday for, see if I can do this, Ben Johnson and Aaron Glenn from the Lions, Shane Steichen, and Jonathan Gannon. I think that's the right list. I might have messed one up. Anyway, they put out a few of them, but they're going to take their time. They're going to continue to do interviews here. But Jim Irsay is a big fan of Jeff Saturday. He believes in him. Despite a 1-7 record as the interim coach, 7 consecutive losses, you've seen Jeff Saturday certainly deflecting the blame for lack of a better term, in talking about how he would do things differently and he believes in different things. We don't know what those things are because he has no track record to lean on. But basically he said, hey, I can't fix everything at this time, so give me the opportunity. That would start with the offense. You'd need to hire a strong offensive coordinator. Jim Harbaugh is a big fan of his. He likes him a lot. He wants him to have a fair shake. So until told otherwise, consider Jeff Saturday a serious candidate in Indianapolis.
It's Tom Pelissero, the NFL Network, a little bit earlier today on the Dan Patrick Show. Now, that to me didn't dismiss the reason why we got this, and shout out to Jim McCann in Southern California that sent me this clip. But somebody called in earlier and suggested that the reason why there was no connection yet, at least reported, between the Colts and Jim Harbaugh was because of his relationship with Jeff Saturday. That didn't sound like that was what Tom Pelissero was trying to say right there. But bottom line of it is there has been at least no reported conversations or interest between the Colts and Jim Harbaugh yet. We'll see. Jay's up next at 239-1070. Jay, welcome to the show.
Hey, JMV, how you doing,
buddy? I'm great.
I don't know how true it is, but I was on the internet today. It looked like somebody had posted something about Miles Turner and the Pacers being close to a deal for like 87, I think it was 87 million for like 4 years, something like that. I don't know how true it is, but you know, if that is the case, man, I hope they go ahead and get that situated, you know, before the trade deadline, as well as the deadline. I think it's March the 1st or something, as far as the extension go. But it'd be nice if they can get that, done, or they can, you know, like I said, focus on the playoffs, man, and try to add a piece to the team for rebounding, because they get clobbered on rebounding. You know, so, and yeah, and another thing I wanted to add, man, I think it's a darn shame, man, that Ballard, man, is sounding like a pervert, man, trying to take advantage of the word struggle.
I mean, for real. I do that all the time with sports arousal, though, so I got, yeah, got no room to talk.
Yeah.
Thanks, Jay.
Like that,
I appreciate you. All right, take it easy, man. Thank you. I do that all the time with sports arousal. Now, I really erred in judgment, because had I known that Ballard was going to, and I heard that quote during the press conference, and I was going to go with Prince and the New Power Generation, Get Off, but I was not heads up. I also failed in that situation. Coming up in just a second, too, because somebody had asked me regarding what Rick Venturi, friend of the show from the Colts Radio Network, had to say about the 1-7 interim campaign of Jeff Saturday. I'll play that for you in a second, but Jonathan is up next at 239-1070. Hello, Jonathan.
Hello, good afternoon. Kevin, one of your callers was spot on earlier, so he kind of stole my question to an extent, but I was thinking... I hate to sound like an amateur sleuth here or anything. I'm not really overthinking, but is something broken with our scouting department? Because, I mean, Ballard is so responsible for everything. But
well, something certainly was broken when they evaluated Matt Ryan's capability of being a quarterback for this team, when I believe it was mentioned that Ballard and Reich watched about 90 minutes of tape and then realized that he was good to go and could play and could help a team. I don't know what the hell they're watching then.
Right, and I don't think that winning ever comes out of Irsay and Ballard's mouth enough. I really wish I hadn't even watched the press conference today, because I didn't find it encouraging at all. But
there's a reason behind that, too. You want to know what that is? It's because Jim Irsay does it. Jim Irsay over the years has set the bar much higher than either Reich or Ballard, and especially Ballard, has wanted it, because they, and this has been brought up a lot, and I hate this word, they talk about the process, and I think Chris brought that up today, the process, and then Jim talks about a winning and multiple Lombardis and all chips in, and then gets everybody stirred up about, well, this is going to be a great season, and then they want to talk about the process. So that's something that has not mixed well for the public to digest over the years here, those level of expectations between owner, general manager, and head coach.
Right. I'm really shocked, actually, that I knew Irsay wasn't going to fire Ballard, but I was shocked that Chris wants the job after the power that's been taken from him. And I just think that every decision and statement from now on is really going to be Irsay speaking through Ballard, with Ballard not getting to have much of a mind of his own. For example, if Irsay wants Levis as the quarterback and Ballard doesn't, it's just going to happen anyway. Just like I think Saturday is going to be the coach. And I don't know why Jeff wants the job of head coach after what he's been through, but I just think it's, how much of a disaster does it take to really go the right direction? I mean, he might, Irsay just might buy into what Keefer believes and say, hey, yeah, Levis is number one. We're not going to dispute that. Let's jump up to number one. And
he ends up
being the wrong guy.
Hey, Jonathan, thank you for the call. I got to run here, but it is with both gigs. I mean, Chris has got a deal contractually through the 2026 season. And, you know, this is the pinnacle for what he does, the gig that he has right now. And the same can be said regarding Jeff Saturday. I would also challenge, certainly with Jeff Saturday, after what he has witnessed, been a part of, you know, this level of embarrassment for a very prideful dude that put such a great deal of winning – and cleared those expectations with that group back in the golden era with Peyton Manning, why he would want to continue to do it, that's easily answered by, well, the finances of it and the fact that you are at the pinnacle of this business when you're coaching an NFL team as well, the pinnacle of what you're doing. Yeah, it'd be easy to go back to ESPN. It'd be easy to get on there and yak it up with Get Up and all this other stuff. But this is the pinnacle of what he wants to do. So that's why he continues to want to do it and want to be a coach, even though things have gone so haywire for him and been so bad for him. Those are the biggest reasons as to why. Back to your calls in a second. Somebody had asked me regarding Colts Roundtable Live last night, a part of the Colts Radio Network, of course. Matt Taylor at the lead, Joe Wrights, and then our friend Rick Venturi. And Rick was asked how he assessed Jeff Saturday on an interim coaching basis, and it sounded like this.
You know, he's way over his head. You know, it's like you take a chiropractor and you make him the head surgeon at Ascension or at the Cleveland Clinic. It's just, you know, you're a snorkeler. You have a surface knowledge of what this job is all about, and you're in the ocean, you know, with guys that have learned their craft and busted their craft and are totally knowledgeable A to Z, and it's just not the same. And you know, he can rationalize on why, you know, why he couldn't do this, but you know, at the end of the day, that last seven games, I would say I was here in the 80s, early 90s. You know, I remember 98, I remember 2011, and I would say that there is no worse stretch in the history of Indianapolis Colts football than that last seven.
It's Rick Venturi last night on Colts Roundtable Live. Somebody asked me if I'd heard what he said. I actually was still sitting here last night when I heard, actually not in here last night, I'm sorry, in the car last night after being a Buffalo Wild Wings, and heard that as well. So I wanted to play that for you from last night again, Colts Roundtable Live. 239-1070. David is up next. Hello, David.
Hey, JMV, what's going on, buddy?
Great to hear from you.
Hey, I found the cure to your knees.
What is that?
You'll be shooting threes like a 19-year-old. Find out where Sean lives and just grab that roach out of his ashtray that he was smoking earlier. Because how could anybody be down on the Pacers with what the Colts are doing right now?
Well, in terms, it comes down to just 33 in general. That is somebody that has qualified him as soft and doesn't like him for a variety of reasons and never will. Nothing he does will ever change a guy like Sean's mind around here. And that makes me sad because that is so ridiculous. It is beyond belief.
I won't keep you too long, but one guy hit on it. He never had the personnel around him. But a quick Colts thing. I personally think it's going to be Saturday and Ballard back. That's just my opinion with Irsay's, how he works. When do we start blaming him if the season next year or even after that goes south with these two guys? I'll let you go. Have a good night.
You got it, David. Thank you very much. Going south with the new head coach and Ballard, is that what he was alluding to right there? Man, he got twisted up a little bit with that. With Ballard, it's just going to be, you know, right now he can live off his words today and, you know, softening the results blow over 6 years with how he started that presser saying that I failed. And a lot of people said, oh, okay then. But it's not just about this year. It was about more of the six-year span. And I was just always been under the impression here that would you go quarterback, coach, and general manager, then go ahead and start clean at all those high-level positions on an NFL team within an NFL organization. But he's not going to do that. And to me, now you're at the lead of the coaching search, and I've said who I believe is perfect, and there has been no reporting that there is any interest or been given any interest on either side, but I've stated my case regarding Jim Harbaugh for you, stated my case regarding the longer-term quarterback for you, and then we'll see if Chris Ballard moving forward has any change of heart. And I've also suggested, I hope it's not about the finances, I hope it doesn't come down to the fact that you know, Jim Irsay doesn't want to pay all this money for two general managers and two head coaches. I hope it's not about that. And it makes me wonder if it may be mostly about the fact that you are having a head coaching search. You are now going to be at some point on the clock to bring in your long-term solution to quarterback. And had this not been the case this particular year, would Chris have been brought back so easily? But certainly with the years remaining on the contract, no doubt that's a significant role and determining factor. Yeah, probably even beyond at some point the trust that you have. Because you have to battle, the trust battles disappointment here. But there are going to be a lot of decisions to be made at the highest levels of your football organization. Would you rather, this is a good point, and you guys can respond to that when we have time coming up on the other side. Would you rather have Jim Irsay handling all general manager, head coach, and then finding those two to get the quarterback coming up in the spring? Or would you rather have Chris here to do head coach and quarterback? I mean, that can easily be asked. Patrick writes this. Oh, this Patrick guy. Why did I even bring this up? 2 years ago, you wanted the Pacers to make trades for assets. I'm not a big assets guy, so I'd have to dispute that. Because I bring it up in a negative all the time. I'm sick and tired of assets. So I don't know if that or me. If they, Pacers, traded Turner, they would have a lot of assets to put with Halliburton and Mathurin. If the Colts get assets, they could get wide receiver to put with a quarterback. What assets are you looking for? Forget that. Why did I even bring this up? Hey, my bad. Operator error for bringing that up. Back to your calls and more on the other side. Charles, Reggie, Chad, and Matt will close it out. Trackside's coming up at 7 o'clock. This is 93.5 and 107.5 The Fan.
Need new tires? Skip the long appointments and bad coffee. With Go Mobile Tires Indy, order tires online and have them installed at your home or office. GoMobileIndy.com. We come to you.
Are you ready to propose to the love of your life? Just as you can imagine all the possibilities for your future, at Shane Company, we can help you imagine all the possibilities for the engagement ring. With the largest selection of unique ring settings in every price range and great financing options, it'll be easy to create the perfect ring. We have solitaire styles, diamond halo rings, designs inspired by nature, and more. For the center stone, we offer natural diamonds and lab-grown diamonds, as well as natural gemstones, including rubies, sapphires, peach morganite, aquamarine, and amethyst. You can also choose a perfectly preset ring. It's proposal ready. At Shane Company, every center stone has been hand-selected by our experts to ensure it meets our high standards for quality and beauty. Unlike other jewelers, our warranty is free, for life, and even covers your center stone. Visit the store or order online. Find the perfect ring for the one you can't let go.
Now you have a friend in the jewelry business. Shane Company and ShaneCo.com.
You do not have to go through yet another year with that knee pain or back pain. Hoosiers with chronic pain are getting real lasting relief from QC Kinetics. I'm Kevin Bowen, and QC Kinetics is the nation's leader in getting that joint pain corrected with advanced regenerative medicine using their unique protocols and healing agents from your own body to target aching joints, repairing and restoring damaged tissue so you can move again with no surgery, no drugs, and no downtime. Got shoulder pain, excruciating hip pain. If you have any arthritis pain or lingering pain from another injury, don't let them operate you or give you more steroids and say no to the pain pills. You call QC Kinetics for a free consultation. It's 317-559-PAIN. Again, locations in Eagle Creek and Greenwood. Make 2023 the year you say goodbye to joint pain. QC Kinetics. It's got people living their best life again. 317-559-PAIN. Locations in Eagle Creek and Greenwood. QC Kinetics.
Bowling, bowling, bowling. Keep them balls a-rolling. Bowling, bowling, bowling. Royal Pin.
The holiday season.
season may be coming to an end, but the fun is just beginning. Make your plans now for a party at any Royal Pin Entertainment Center. Treat your employees to a great time with bowling. Appetizers from chips to heavy hors d'oeuvres, food packages from pizza to prime rib, and a wide range of party options from just bowling to laser tag, limitless VR, go-karts, arcade, and more. You can upgrade with adult beverages, craft beer, premium spirits, and frozen drinks. Want a custom party? Their sales team can make it happen. Reward your team for their hard work. Email events at royalpin.com or visit royalpin.com to book today. That's events at royalpin.com.
Royal Pin, bowling, bowling. Royal Pin, bowling.
Doing more in the community means that I get out and I volunteer.
Hi, I'm Hannah Yeagerbush here at Teachers Treasures, and we nominated David Barabee because he's such a great volunteer leader. He does so much for us to make our mission possible to serve teachers in Marion County.
And I'm Jiffy Lube owner Jennifer Sanner. At Jiffy Lube, we are rewarding Hoosier volunteers who use their vehicle to do more to make Indiana a better place to live.
My vehicle really allows me the ability to be where they need me, either downtown, at the store, or out on a route, or working for the mobile operator.
Each month, Jiffy Lube of Indiana provides a volunteer free vehicle maintenance for a year, whether it's someone who delivers smiles and supplies or drives somewhere to serve on site. Jiffy Lube supports local givers who count on their car to do more for Indy, and we love to hear their stories.
If you know a volunteer who impacts your community, nominate them today to receive a year's worth of free vehicle maintenance. Just click the Do More tab at JiffyLubeIndiana.com.
Guys, if you've noticed a lack of energy, motivation, and drive, it could be low testosterone, so schedule your complete health assessment at Low T Center today. They now offer the convenience of monitored self-inject at-home testosterone treatments. That's $155 a month cash pay or is covered by most health insurance. If you don't live near a Low T Center or you just need the convenience of the at-home treatment, Low T Center makes it easy. To get started on treatment, it's only the first two visits in person. That's LowTCenter.com to schedule your appointment today. LowTCenter.com. That's Low T Center, reinventing men's health care.
Plays more new country. 97.1 Hank FM.
The Pacers head to the Big Apple to face the New York Knicks tomorrow night at 7 on 93.5 and 107.5 The Fan.
The Ride with JMV.
Well, not really. I felt it on my leg. Come on, I don't want to see it.
93.5 and 107.5 The Fan.
Even when they're pissed and they boo and the criticism, and that means they care. It means they're invested. They care. Like, I would rather have that than apathetic people that didn't care. Like, I handle that well. Like, I'm still going to show up, and I'm still going to show up in public. And when they make a comment to me, it's okay. I handle it well. I get emails, calls. You have no idea. And I do everything I can to return all of them. They deserve that. Our fans deserve better.
That's Chris Ballard right there. There's no doubt about that. Then give them better. How about that? From here on out, give them better. Give them better. Shut me up. Shut those also that have been highly critical. Shut everybody up. We shall see, because this is not going to be... I would disagree with Greg Rakestraw, who was on with me earlier today, and respectfully disagree about the fact that I don't think this is going to be like a one-year thing where if things don't go well again next year, that then they'll be searching for a new GM. I think Chris is going to be here for the better part of the remaining contract, because he is going to draft a new quarterback. He's going to hire, unless Jim Irsay hires Jeff Saturday, a new coach. He's going to be here for a while. He must have talked that up really well with Jim Irsay. There's no question. But, yes, all right, then stop with the struggle and show everybody what you can do. Reggie's at 239-1070. Reggie, go ahead.
What's up, man? This is Homer Reg. Man, Sean don't know what he's talking about. I guess he's never negotiated a contract or or pay scale or anything. You never take the first offer that's given to you. Miles has been on the trading block for, what, the last 3 years?
Exactly.
And now he holds all the keys.
Well, they brought somebody in for him in the summertime. DeAndre Ayton brought in, and they signed him to an offer sheet. So he's been through this mess before. Yeah.
And it's going to cost you at least $115. If I was Miles, you're going to at least start where you offered DeAndre Ayton to me. And you know what, man? I got to take back some of the things I said last year and 2 years ago. You know, I was about, man, fire Kevin Pritchard. But he has did some good stuff that has made me reconsider my thoughts, making me want to apologize to him for saying he needed to be fired. I like the moves that he's made. And I've been on the Chris Ballard, fire him for the last 2 years, bandwagon. I'm hoping, since Irsay's going to keep him, that he has a turnaround like this, too, and he can prove me wrong next year. I doubt it, but I hope he does. And I just think we've got to re-sign Miles. I think we've got to keep Hill on the team. And I think we just got to get some beef up front, get some girth, some big guys to help Miles rebound. They don't necessarily need to score the ball. They're going to dive for the ball and whatever. You've got to keep this team together and just add pieces. Bug assets. We've seen what assets did for the Colts and Pacers. They don't do jack. Let's build through the draft, get our teams right, and hopefully Kevin proves me wrong.
Anti-assets Reggie, that's my favorite. Thank you, Reggie. Chad's up next. Go ahead, Chad.
Yes, we'll love your show there, JMV.
Thank you, buddy. Appreciate it, Chad. Go ahead.
I just wanted to touch on something you said earlier about, you know, if there's a man out there that you want to go get, as far as, you know, we need a quarterback really bad. I was taking a look at these guys that have the most firepower, and one of them is Seattle. And I know that I've just become one of the biggest Geno Smith fans there is, because I think he's still kind of auditioning for the future for those guys. And I think that it depends on whether he lays an egg or not in the playoffs on whether or not they're going to be trying to move up. And I just kind of wanted to hear your thoughts on that and where you think we stand compared to their firepower. And I'll get off.
You got it. Thank you, Chad, for that. I'll tell you what, I'm going to have to answer that coming up tomorrow. And James, write this down. Jay, Charles, and Matt left on hold. Jay, Charles, and Matt, all three of you call tomorrow and you will get on before anybody else. I'm going to leave the door open for you tomorrow because we got to go right now. We can't get you on. Jay, Charles, Matt, first right to join the show coming up tomorrow. James, great job from you. Greg Rakestraw, Zach Keefer, podcast 1075thefan.com. Trackside's coming at you at 7. Back with you in studio tomorrow at 3 o'clock. I will talk with you then. 93.5 and 1075 The Fan. Have a great night.
.5 and 107.5 The Fan, your home for indie sports. Now with even more ways to listen.
Listen on air.
Online at 107.5thefan.com.
And on our free app.
Stay connected to all things indie sports, including the latest news, show blogs, and catch up on what you've missed with our podcast.
We're never more than just a click away.
Download our app at Google Play and on the App Store. From your home for indie sports.
93.5 and 107.5 The Fan.
Hey there, it's Jake Query for AAA, and I don't know about you, but wintertime always gets my mind wondering in terms of vacations. Recently, I went to Barcelona and Florence, Italy. Both were absolutely fantastic. I would love to get somewhere warm to escape and see sunshine for the first time in seemingly forever. And no matter where you're thinking about heading, my friends at AAA can help you get the best price on your next vacation at the AAA Vacation Expo. It's Saturday, January 21st at the JW Marriott downtown. Exclusive vacation deals, expert presentations, complimentary travel planning, and more. And the best part, it's all free. You don't even have to be a AAA member to attend. So whether you're looking to travel this year, next year, or beyond, save the date for a AAA Vacation Expo.